Hey, everybody, welcome to Noir Bar. What is this, night 84? I think 84. God, we've done a lot of these. Far. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
It's not too early for that, I think. So.
Sorry, not really.
Well, you know how people are. Don't start saying Merry Christmas before it's freshman. You know, I've been telling a lot of people. That the tradition for the longest time has been, you know, Christmas, you don't trim the tree and decorate the tree until Christmas Eve. And that's when you wrap all your gifts, because that's the starting of the 12 days of Christmas that run clear through December into January. Because you don't celebrate Christmas until Christmas Eve. And it's the 12 days of Christmas with the Lords a-leaping and the maids a-milking and whatnot.
All right.
So yeah.
It's not the build-up to Christmas?
No. No. I mean, people are getting things ready for Christmas. Like, we're talking the Victorian era and whatnot, and medieval times.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's the way they would do it. That's where the 12 days of Christmas phrase comes from. Is it the 12 days of Christmas starts on Christmas Day? That's day one. When somebody gave somebody a partridge and a pear tree for some reason.
Yeah, that's a weird one. Why that?
Mr. Scott, what you know how people are. I.
No. Okay.
I'd like to answer your question, man, but I'm not sure what it is, honestly.
All right.
I know how people be do. Yeah.
It's as far as we got.
People be like they do. And they are as they be. And I know. That's an appropriate answer, I think. Oh, that kind of tree trimming. Gotcha.
Welcome to Nuova.
Yeah, I know. Just I myself may have poured a drink already. Got started. So, yeah, it's Christmas.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And, I am sort of like off for Christmas. You're off for Christmas, right, Far? You're not working?
Yeah.
They're not forcing you to go work in the hot summer sun because it's summer down there now, you poor bastards.
No. Yeah, no, I'm not working.
Oh, good. Well, yeah, myself as well, but I still got a fuck ton of shit to do, which sucks. And causes things like missed AAA streams, you know, shitty shit.
Yeah. How did that go, by the way?
Terribly.
Was it as hellish as you were describing it to me?
More so. It was like that. It was like that, but more so. It involved extra family drama and hospitalitic situations and I don't know. Who wants to hear that? It's a long...
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
I mean... You know
not
how
live
women,
anyway.
I'll sum it up this way. You know how women are.
I know how this specific woman is.
Be they your mother or not.
That you're referring to.
You know, like it's just like, you know, my mom didn't help with the dates, family dramas, let me tell you. Things just kept getting worse and worse and worse.
I am so shocked by that statement.
Really? Okay, you want to see an odd picture?
What the fuck am I looking at?
I don't know. Here.
What the fuck is that?
You can already see it. So like, here, look. What is this? Chat, someone help me.
What is this?
Cougar Knife went through some trouble to put together this piece of art. And I appreciate anybody who puts together some, like, this is obviously some AAA art. You got drunk, got Sinatra, got myself in the background there. But what is it? And so I just wrote, wow.
Yeah, what is it?
Like, thank you for the effort, though I remain uncertain as to what it is I'm looking at.
Yeah, I can't tell you.
Yeah, I got nothing. Thanks, Cougar Knife.
It almost feels like it's a reference to something, like, just something?
Well, I clearly think it's a reference. I'm thinking.
I don't know what it is.
Like, I've never seen. What's the movie with the big old orc? cartoon. There's like five of them. Shrek. I thought it was like I don't know. He's dressed in green, so I thought it might be a Shrek thing. I don't know.
Ogre.
He's an Holly. Ogre. Okay, fine.
He's an ogre. Because ogres have layers, Holly.
They do?
That's the meme.
All right.
Ogres have layers, just like onions have layers.
Uncle Mike says, missed you Wednesday. Well, I missed you too, Uncle Mikey. Yeah, it was an unfortunate thing. And so, but I was also thinking, big fat person, little people standing behind them. I'm like, is this a Return of the Jedi reference? Is that Jabba the Hutt? And you got, no, that can't be. Like, am I supposed to be Salacious Crumb back there? The little weirdo sand monkey dude that hung out with, that was Jabba the Hutt's pet? And that would make Sinatra what? Boba Fett? I don't know, man. I'm fucking guessing.
I have no clue.
I can't look away. I keep staring at it. Like, we've done this image. Like, we can move on, but I don't feel that we can because, like, no information is.
Move on.
I
look up the image. Do it.
No. Not until it's explained, damn it.
It's not going to be explained.
Okay, hold on. Mr. Scott thinks it might be an obese hunchback of Notre Dame. Okay. Why does he have like steampunk wires coming out of him then and shit? And it looks like it's in like a weird alien cantina. I mean, that's a fair guess. I mean, anything is. And the hunchback of Notre Dame got rich because he's like wearing like a whole bunch of gold rings.
Okay, mystery solved, I guess. It's Jack and Daxter, whatever the fuck that is. The game, it looks like.
Really?
Thanks, Talik.
Oh. Oh, God.
That's what it appears to be.
Sam's here.
Oh. Oh, no. The French have invaded.
You know what it's like when the French show up, right?
What? Yeah, they start handing out cheese. I don't fucking know. I'm sorry.
Is that what they do? They hand out cheese? I would like Frenchmen more if they gave out free cheese, honestly. I'd be much more okay with them.
Damn, where's our cheese?
Or you're a pick. Hold on. Let me move my mic when I move myself to. Hold on. Instead of moving myself, why don't I move the keyboard? It's meant for that.
Yeah. Yes, it is.
Professional streaming here. Just typing away.
Okay.
I don't know how to do things. Far, entertain the audience. I'm doing something. Speak to them.
What?
Talk to them.
Fuck. What?
It was less than.
Hey, everyone.
How long ago was it that you told me that you were very charming? I was like. 15 minutes ago? 10 minutes ago?
I am a very charming person.
That's what she led me to believe. She said, I am very charming. And,
yeah, this was in response to me, obviously not. That was the joke. Fucker. Hello, hello. Hello, Sam.
No cheese.
Oh, God. What? He's here now.
I don't get cheese? Why?
Rudeness. Rudeness, young lady.
And if it's anyone who can judge rudeness, it's the French, am I right?
Damn straight.
Hold on.
No, of course there's cheese. Of course there's cheese.
Turn up Sam.
Never show up to a bar.
I was about to, you know, use my Australian persuasion here.
Oh.
Alright, so here.
Steal shit, because we're criminals.
So here's the thing.
Oh, right, okay.
Bar's very, selective eater, let's say. I'm going to go so far as call her picky.
Friends?
Yeah, that's what I mean. It's odd. There's no consistency to it. I like yolks. Whites are terrible. Crunch is a flavor.
Crunch is absolutely a flavor.
and whites are terrible.
Nobody ever ordered an egg yolk omelet ever. Ever. Nowhere. It's never happened.
I don't even like omelets.
You know what, Mr. Dub? I'm gonna do that right the fuck now.
you're gonna call up a local eatery, call Uber Eats. I want an egg yolk omelet. Like, really? See, Thomas, thank you for the $2. The fuck is going on here? This isn't Saturday morning, and AAA was noticeably absent. Now I gotta divide myself between AP and you. AP still going? Oh, yeah, I guess he would be. Yeah, I guess he would be. Huh. It's right in the name of his show, Late Night Show. Fuck AP. Let's just.
Who even is AP? This is where the real.
I hear he used to be a frog. He should get along very well.
Used to be a frog.
He did used to be a frog. It's true.
No, he being digested.
No, he's Adonis Paul. Let's just go over there and see if he's still streaming. Oh my God, he is streaming.
Yeah, he is.
Leave the kids alone.
Leave the kids alone.
Fuck them kids.
Don't fuck them kids.
Yeah, maybe rephrase that.
Oh, Jesus.
How are you, Sam?
I'm actually quite sick at the moment. I appear to have poisoned myself.
What? How?
I bought a bag of Brazil nuts a while ago.
Brazil nuts are the worst nuts. They have been plaguing nut platters for decades. Brazil deserves to be chastised with every form of economic and diplomatic pressure we can bring to bear.
I mean, this
is going to happen as soon as Brazil nuts were mentioned.
you know about my hatred of Brazil nuts, Mark?
I know.
Oh, okay.
Yes, I have heard the rants many times.
Okay, it's not new. I do detest Brazil nuts.
What is wrong with Brazil nuts? Okay, thanks, Michael.
Their texture's weird. They've got a funky little taste. They just, you know, they're no good.
Apparently they poison French people.
And they poison French people.
Well, see, this is the thing. They have a high amount of selenium in them. Yes.
I did not know that.
Yes, it is. A very high amount of selenium. Your standard intake should be anywhere between 45 and 100 micrograms a day, and the average Brazil nut contains about 65 micrograms. I ate like 20 of those bad boys.
Discord app launched. Yeah, that's what I wanted. I'm trying to do something. No, keep telling us about your story. I'm listening.
Okay. Yeah. That's all there really is to it. I ate 20 of those bad boys.
And such.
Yeah. But the thing was, is I completely spaced on them, you know, having this, toxic chemical compound. And I was like, these taste delicious. I love them so much. The texture is great. They are crunchy.
A man presented to the emergency room with pains in his stomach. Have you ever watched Chubby Emu?
Basically, yeah. Yeah, that would be the start of a Chubby Emu video, wouldn't it? It turns out he ate a shit ton of Brazil nuts, but the doctors didn't know that. They kept testing him for all this other shit.
Because he refused to tell the doctors what had gone wrong.
He thought there was nothing wrong with eating this amount of Brazil nuts. He'd been doing it every day for 5 years.
That's right.
This is what happens to your liver after eating only Brazil nuts for 5 years. That'd be the video.
There we go.
That would be the video.
We're just gonna stream snipe AP. I don't feel like doing a show, so let's just use his. That's cool.
What? Oh. Wow.
What? Nah, it's fine.
The Brazil nut story wasn't enough for you?
No, AP and I were friendly, man. He's cool. He was on our show he was on Noir Bar Christmas Eve last year, remember? We're friendly. It's cool.
Yeah, I remember.
He'll be totally fine with me stream sniping his stream.
Copyrighted music.
I think that's a touch different from, you know, literally lifting his stream content.
I'm totally not stream sniping you.
Oh my God. You're actually putting that in chat.
Sure.
Anyway, God. Yeah. You know what?
Conclusion to my story.
Yes, go on.
Conclusion.
My final evolution. I am now a poison frog.
Great. Well done. Well done on your new evolution.
You can get away with everything right now. The Democrats are not.
God, it's like AP's on the show, but not. And we're having to work far less. This is great. Why haven't I thought of this before?
Because this is some of the laziest shit you could ever accomplish.
Well, Susie and Jeff, that's right. Three smashing.
You went through all this work to grab other videos and shit, and this is awesome.
This is what happens when you side with the fucking criminals. This is what happens when being a thief carries less of a penalty than stopping a thief.
Well,
yes.
So this is a fun show.
I'm delighted to be here.
In the store. It's unclear if the store was open, but employees indefinitely freaked out.
Well, apparently a T-Mobile was robbed. It's a good thing AP went and found that footage for us, so I didn't have to. The Spectral Umbreon is over there going, damn it, Polly, it's just...
They
don't know which direction they've gone, but this is the third. The other two were in North
Dakota. No, it's fine. It's fine.
So all over the San Fernando Valley.
Look, didn't you have like a shit ton of articles? You're like, yeah, I got all this stuff. I've got like stuff for a Noir Bar and another Noir Bar.
There's our man. There's AP. Yeah, well, yeah, I had a shit. I have a shit.
You know who's going to pay the price?
Shit ton of articles, but.
The innocent people who live in those neighborhoods.
But that doesn't mean that I should have to, you know, use them.
How can you compete with that animated face?
That's what I'm saying. It's just such a great... Hold on. I'm just going to go check to make sure that I'm not getting a content warning here. Hold on. No, I'm not. It's fine. It's, everything's fine. See, YouTube doesn't care about AP.
Yeah, until he starts playing, like, Spice Girls or some shit.
Which I asked him, before, if you remember, Far, before we went live... Last Christmas Eve, how do you get away with playing all the copyright shit? And he goes, I don't know, I just do it. I'm like, don't you get copyright claims? He's like, sure. I was like, oh.
Yeah, he just doesn't give a shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know, I was there. But like, yeah, no, he just doesn't give a shit. But you do.
Yeah, well, I'm not sure why I should.
Yeah, I don't know why you do either at this point.
Well, actually, to answer C. Thomas's question, what's going on? Thank you for giving me the idea for stream sniping AP, by the way, C. Thomas. It's like, you know, why the hell are you streaming right now?
You're
well, it's Christmas time, and Far's off from work, and I am not due to be awake at any time early tomorrow morning, so I am enjoying some drinks. You know what my next drink's going to be, Sam?
What is it?
It's from your motherland, Calvados. No, I'm not kidding. I love Calvados. It's great. What?
It's not bad. It's not bad.
It's not bad. It's not up to my standard. It's just.
But look, I have a particularly refined palate. I'm just doing it. Brazil nuts and foie gras. It's right there, you know.
Brazil nuts and foie gras. See, this is like, you know, you picture the way the French talk about themselves. You know, they don't have drunkards. They don't have winos. They got guys laying in the street drinking champagne. They got champagnos. You know, it's eating warmed brie that they've cooked over a small can fire, you know.
Yes, our junkies, you know, in parks and such. It's not heroin. That's Pinot Noir.
Right. Okay, what is this guy doing? Is this like an attempted theft? Hold on, we need the audio again.
Yes, you're right, and you got to meet with that because now we're clearly not looking. But we will have another opportunity.
Problem right there.
Yeah, you know, I have no idea.
Is he Russian and posing
even
for a photograph?
There's a camera right on top of it.
In fact, I know exactly what
it is. He seems to be wearing a Nike.
And we see everything he's doing.
Or Adidas or whatever it is.
But he doesn't think those cameras are for... they work, you know. They think they're all for show. That's what people mistake with the cameras. They think they're just for show and they don't work and we don't use them and we don't look at them. He thinks we're looking away from him.
Do they take a picture of you when you shit in the street?
Do your stupid shit. Okay, he tries to hide it. Thinks about how he's gonna slowly move it into his shoe, okay? And
he's gonna rock
and he's still wondering if he should do it or not. He's looking around, acting as if we don't know what we're doing. Bro, it's the way you dressed, the way you look.
You're racially profiling. We just heard it. He just said it.
You know, people really should dress smarter if they're gonna steal, come to a store and steal, okay? If you look like that, we're gonna be watching you the whole time.
If okay? he's white? Is and that what you're saying?
Put it in his shoes. This so is so racist. In. He's like, take it out. Because no, by that time, we've had I enough of it, okay? The, we already know he has one in his pocket. And then he tries to see another one. And we're not going to play along with this shit, okay? I'm like, take it out. And he's pretending, no, it's not there. You know, even though it's on the other shoe. Okay? Run. He's getting aggressive. And I keep telling him from the other side of the register, I'm like, take it out. It's right there. So he gives it, puts it back and tries to walk off. And then my friend's nope, take out the other one. And he acts as if there is no other one. I'm like, okay. You want your fucking phone, bro? It's right here. You dumb.
Too bad you forgot your phone, you stupid bitch.
Dumbass, take the other charger out and take your phone.
Sorry, I had an important DM to read from a colleague. I usually follow him on the. Certain people are more privileged than others. And it's an exciting email, and I'm glad to be a part of it.
Want to get the fuck out of here.
It's an exciting email. I'm glad to be part of it. Someone DM'd him and told us. They told him we're stream sniping him.
Don't fucking come back. Thank you.
Or he got a business offer that was actually worth something because he does real business and I'm just, you know.
You just hear what this motherfucker said.
Fucking come back. Thank you. Out the other charger. Put shit on the counter. I'm like, here's your phone.
We'll do some other stories. We'll come back and see what AP's up to.
Thank you. Come again.
Oh my Here's god. Okay, phone. So this is gonna be Don't a very fucking come thing, back.
He said the
god
thing.
Damn it, it's a dumb.
He said the thing. Thank you, come
point.
Again.
Reflex, what? My friends.
He said the
oh
thing.
My god.
I saw Polly scoot by real fast when that was catching up. How's it going, Polly? And now, ladies and gentlemen, glow or no? For those of you who are new and you don't know what a glowy is, it's typically a CIA agent trying to false flag a racist incident. But civilians are getting in on the fun, too.
Yeah,
let's make a decision
aware,
if this is
or
real.
Or he's just like, man, I don't give a shit.
Yeah, I just don't think he cares.
I don't like fan niggers. I don't like brown.
Whoa.
Okay, yeah, shut it down.
Shut it down. The goyim, no. This is, no. No. Holy fuck.
Well, it was a fun channel while it lasted.
Yeah, yeah.
Enjoyed doing Noir Bar with you, Polly.
Those are the dangers.
This is the last Noir Bar.
Those are the dangers in sniping AP. He gets away with N-bombs. No one else does. It's a mystery no one understands. It's like...
But how many fun channels does the guy have? He's like... Like, constantly, like, well, I'm banned from this one for streaming for a bit. Let's jump to this one. Like, how many times does that happen? A lot. A lot. Oh, fuck. Well, what do we have next? No?
I don't know. Where should we start? We got space stuff. Oh, we have two Australian Christmas quizzes, Aussie Christmas quizzes for Far.
That's my favorite.
I threatened you with that.
Thanks, Polly. I know you did.
And it's
fuck me.
Let's start with the scope down here on planet Earth, and then we can, you know, zoom out, basically.
Yeah, fair enough.
Zoom.
Okay, zoom back. We'll go over here. Fortunately, Far knows so many of these. Actually, I don't think you know this one. Do you know this one? Did you see this one?
What is it?
Spinda Bifta show jumper wins landmark legal case over her wrongful conception. Eva Toombs, 20, who sued her mother's GP claiming she should have never been born, could win millions in damages.
Well, that's both really fucked up and dark.
Yes.
What an unfortunate last night.
Yeah. Bifida spends up to 24 hours a day connected to tubes. She claims her mother's general practitioner failed to advise her on vital supplements to take. Evie sued Dr. Philip Mitchell for wrongful conception. Say that again. Wrongful conception in a landmark case. And Judge Rosalind Coe, QC, whatever QC stands for, backed Evie's case and awarded her the right to a huge compensation payout.
So, she's basically going like, fuck yeah, eugenics?
I'm dead. I shouldn't be here. I should have never been born, I guess. But forged a career in show jumping. Yeah, I mean, like, there she is connected to tubes. I mean, like, all right, yeah. But you're a professional show jumper, which isn't easy. Equestrian skills are not easy to build. They take a lifetime. You're a pro at it.
Holy shit. But, like, also, it's just, like, I should never have been born.
Yeah.
I'm gonna do show jumping. Like, what?
Oh, boy. I thought I had some misconceptions.
Wow. Wow. What is it that she last month the unique wrongful conception damages claim that Sue Doctor just didn't advise her mother to take vital supplements before getting pregnant. She claimed that if the doctor had told her mother she needed to take folic acid supplements to minimize the risk of spina bifida affecting her baby, she would have been put off from getting pregnant until she had done so, and Evie would never have been born at all.
Okay.
So the doctor didn't advise that you should be taking folic acid to put off the risks of spina bifida, which are a possibility, not a necessary outcome. Probably. Yeah. And the judge decided to go along with this?
Yeah.
And the mother bears no culpability at all. Oh.
Not just that, but it's like... Wait, so would it put off getting pregnant if she had done, like, you're making a hell of an assumption, like, hell of an assumption on the mother there.
Well, it's just like, she would have, there's so many would-haves, right? Like, well, if the doctor had advised this, she would have done that. Yeah, well, my doctor advised me to stop smoking and drinking.
What did I know about health?
I'm just saying. He said you smoke, you drink. I'm like, yeah. He goes, well, how much? And I tell him, and he's like, yeah, you should cut down or quit entirely.
And look at him now.
Yeah. I'm a spiteful man. I started smoking more and drinking in the mornings.
Oh, Polly, I hardly think keeping drinking until, 2, 3 a.m. is considered morning drink.
Yeah, I mean my mornings, so late afternoon. Like, yeah. You know the way proto-dawn theory works. It's not the next day until I wake up.
Yes, it is the ally of the modern intellectual.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And Peter in chat's got it right. My existence is your fault. That is a good summary of what's being said here. Yes.
Also, how depressing a mindset must that be of, like, I should never have been born.
And I gotta say, if you don't know that there's a disease called spina bifida, you very well might think that this is a foreigner named Spina Bifida who's a show jumper that won a landmark legal case. It's possible.
Oh god, that's
Missing European or something.
Yeah, Miss Bifida is attached to tubes all day. Spina was heard to comment.
Why isn't her last name capitalized? Must be some weird European thing.
I just can't wait until she takes this to the logical conclusion, appeals to the metaphysical Supreme Court. I'm suing God! Shouldn't have let me be born.
Right? That Episcopalian church has got a hell of a suit and a mitten full of papers coming to them, by God. It's all their fault. They told me everything would be fine.
Reports indicate that Jehovah pictured here. Was sentenced to 230 billion years in the galactic slam.
Speaking of people with strange names, this marijuana dispensary owner named Alfonso Blunt. Jesus Christ.
What?
I was made for this, literally.
I don't know. I mean, we live in a world where chocolate could be called a a fucking truffle and soaking a fungus. We got guys named Blunt that sell weed. There's somebody who sold national security or leaked national security secrets named Reality Winner. I want off this planet.
I like to think that Alfonso here is Russian.
Why?
There's something
Alfonso
about
Alfonso Blunt.
There's something about that name that, you know.
Alfonso strikes you as a Russian? I thought you were going to make a black Russian drink joke at this.
Damn it, Polly, I was trying to lead into that.
Wait a
minute.
Yeah.
Dr. Funchal's is not his real name. Very likely. I don't know. Who knows? He's an Oakland business owner, Alfonso Blunt. Or Al. Liberal cities have been overrun. Oh, yeah, so what's the big deal? Marijuana dispensary owner claims crime is so bad in the Bay Area, he was safer dealing drugs on the streets before he opened the dispensary. So let me see if I get this right. You own a legally operating dispensary and are talking about the time you sold drugs on the street? Okay, there is a big process involved in getting a licensure to open a dispensary. You know. Probably not a good idea to announce to the world, especially on Fox News, that you're a former drug dealer.
Yeah, that's probably not the smartest thing to do, but his last name is Blunt.
Yeah. I mean...
Sir.
This is why...
Much like British who name their children Jeeves, they're doomed to a life of butlersdom. This man's path was chosen.
Very, very blunt. Look, if you were going to go buy weed, do you want your weed dealer's name to have Blunt somewhere?
I
think it'd be very fitting.
I don't know. It's more believable than if their name was like Cannabis or something. Johnny Cannabis, like that just sounds made up. Alfonso Blunt
Cannabis
could be a real name.
No. Their name is Can E Bus.
go with a rhymey name so you know that it's made up. Like, Annie Indica. That'd be good. Can rob a dispensary, by the way. Where this all comes from, like, this is on Crowder's site.
Holly, there's a line in there. At the bottom, where it just says, yes, his last name is Blunt.
Well, okay. Steven Crowder, it is, it's true.
Just like, but yeah, yes, that is really his last name.
Yes, and it's, I mean, this is louder with Crowder, but remember, he also made a big hairy deal, and justifiably so, when he went undercover to the clinic talking about hormone replacement therapy, and the doctor that was there giving advice to all the people seeking advice on getting hormone replacement therapy for transitioning. His name was literally Dr. Rex Butt.
Yeah, right. Dr. Rex Butt. I forgot about him.
Now, we're not saying the man is an anal aficionado, but he wrecks butt.
But he's an anal.
I'm waiting
to list of just like unfortunate or really great last names and do like a ranking someday of just these people. Like, what is the worst / best name to have in your profession?
I'm just waiting to hear from Alfonso Blunt's, you know, mentor and business partner, you know, Richard Doobie.
Dick Doobie?
Yeah. Dick Doobie.
Dick Doobie, yeah.
Oh, Dick Doobie.
Yeah, and Frank Capp gets it. Dr. Smash Ass. That's what it sounds like. Dr. Rex Butt. What is Rex short for, by the way? Reginald? Rexall?
Rexamillion?
Rexamillion. Did you... Okay, Far's cut off.
I did. What? Rexamillion? What? What do you mean I'm cut off?
You're cut off from further liquor. Alex Jones wonders if Joe Biden used a weather weapon to cause deadly tornadoes. I miss this man.
Yes.
I do.
Yeah.
Wonderful human being.
Yeah. miss him too. Like the day he was taken off of YouTube was a sad day indeed.
I love the little informatic here. In this article, Joe Biden! Tell him he's surprised.
Right.
Yeah, he told listeners on the Alex Jones show on Monday that the U.S. government developed weather weapons in the late 1950s. He cited a talk from former director John, yes, I voted for the Communist Party twice, Brennan, as supposed evidence of existence of a secret government geoengineering systems. In Brennan, yes, I voted for the Communist Party twice's speech, delivered at the 2016 Council of Foreign Relations event, he discussed the geopolitical risks of geoengineering the climate and the costs and benefits of using it as a potential tool against climate change. Or
Dr. Functional is right.
You could put economic and diplomatic pressure on India and China, the largest polluters of the planet that's never mentioned. Oh, I was in Minecraft YouTube, I mean. That's not really the
guys,
way that it works. This is
Dr. Functional brings up a very good point about our man Dr. Rex Butt. Rex isn't short form, it just means king.
That's
so his
I
name
said.
Is King Butt.
He's Ass King.
Is it?
Cool.
So he is. So but it's just like, yeah, his name is King, right? But it's just
No, I know the like Regina Butt. As female royalty, but male is Rex, is it? Okay.
Yes.
Rex?
Yep. Oh, didn't
it's
know
like
that.
Tyrannosaurus Rex.
Huh.
Yeah. That's what it means.
Just check in, see what
I still think it should
AP's
be Rex-a-million sounds great.
Oh yeah, AP still streams, still going. Okay. Just check in. Space Ghost is really intent on typing something. It's good. It's good. Okay.
Yeah, that's a lot of R's.
Yeah. Oh, he's just talking to chat.
That's what Dr. Rex Butt is looking for.
Hello,
lots
AP.
R's. Lots of R's.
Chatception.
King Butt is looking
hey,
for
us. Hey, broadcasting live from Adonis Ball's Pleasure Palace Hotel, Casino Resort, and Gun Range. I'm Adonis Ball, your food and beverage administrator, and I congratulate you for making it just through the first half
and
of
also,
late night with Adonis Ball, but don't go anywhere, because the second half is always worse than the first. You all aware of how that shit works.
Yeah,
and in the second half, I've got my trans wife received death threats after coming out, a little FPS cop, we got some Merry Christmas cringe talk, kids
okay,
breaking into our house and stealing shoes in Texas.
I need to stream snipe you.
What else do we have coming up in the second half? We've got public transit problems and more, so don't go anywhere. Ladies and gentlemen, as always,
we're not going anywhere, AP.
We're
only halfway. Good to hear.
But you know, we've done so much of that. Don't donate anymore. You guys have blessed me enough. I think we're just fine on donations. If you wouldn't mind hitting the like button, it's free. That would be cool. If it would help. Or sharing this on your favorite social media. Or if you're looking to get something for your money, Delta 8 is now a federally legal form.
Evil one stealing. I wouldn't go that far. It's promoting a fellow content creator that I greatly admire and respect. How about that?
Uh-huh.
What?
Yep. Promoting to a smaller audience than he has at the moment. Yep.
We're assuming that there are some people
promotion.
Here who do not watch Adonis Paul and are not aware of how great his show is. And yeah. So it's a smaller audience, admittedly.
And how many N-bombs are said on that show?
Yeah. Well, I'm not responsible for his content. I'm merely proxying it. That works, right?
Uh-huh.
Mirroring, if you will.
I mean, sure.
Fuck, how's my pause game, huh? Look at that. He's ready. He's ready.
He's in. Ready or something.
Sorry, AP, I'm skipping. It's fine. It's fine. You're into the glory holes. That's
like
your thing. It's cool. It's cool. All right, moving along.
I like them.
All right.
Moving along. Okay, yeah, so the show jumper doesn't think she should be born, but wants plenty of money now that she's here. Let's see. Oh, yes, this guy, a brilliant man. Man posed as his brother to dodge police, but his brother was also a wanted man. Oops.
huh. Yeah, maybe you should have checked that before you tried to pose as your brother.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe, like,
excuse me. Excuse me. I would have muted my mic, but couldn't get my hand up there in time. There's no my mouse. Okay. In Singapore. Yeah. Great.
Singapore.
A motorist involved in two unrelated fatal traffic accidents in 2008 and 2014 was caught driving a car last year, even though he had been disqualified from doing so. In an attempt to get himself off the hook, Jason Chia Jungji, 40, gave false information to a police officer by claiming to be his younger brother, but in a twist, the court heard that the brother was wanted by the authorities at the time, and Chia was arrested.
Well, is this entire family just caught up in crime?
Right?
Okay. What is happening here?
I don't know. Like, call around. Talk to your cousins who vaguely resemble you and say, okay, dude, are you currently wanted by the police? No. Okay. All right. Well, yeah, I'm like driving when I've been restricted from doing so. That's it. So I'm going to be calling myself you from now on. Just so you know.
No, I mean, you know, I think you pass. We're both very devilishly handsome, in Polly.
You're handsome as this man? I don't know about that. And this guy's a real head turner.
Lady killer.
Mm-hmm. Oh, good lord. Okay, so.
He's 40?
Yes, he is.
Look at that hairline.
What? Are you losing hair, Sam?
A little bit. It's getting a little thin on top.
I've noticed that the only people who tend to make that commentary are people that are, you know. I didn't even look at his fucking hairline because I got, you know, my hair is long and luxuriant, so it's just, you know, it's fine.
Oh, I mean, mine too. I just I've always had the widow's peak since birth, and yeah, it's beginning to get a little thin right near the crown now. So I appreciate these things. I appreciate that gentleman's fantastic hairline.
Nice. Not so much the haircut, the hairline.
Oh no, the cut's terrible.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's not a good man.
Okay, so burglary that's suspect true. Held at gunpoint by Fairfax County resident. I like this story a lot. And here are the stories that never go wide. This is why this is like local news. Fairfax City, Virginia news. Like, it doesn't get more local than that, right? They arrested a man in connection with a Sunday morning burglary at a residence. Officers responded at 8:22 a.m. A preliminary investigation revealed the man, whom the residents did not know, entered their home, displayed a knife, and lunged at one of them. Armed with a firearm, the victim discharged one round into the living room floor and then held the man at gunpoint till the police arrived. The police officers arrested the man, and no injuries were reported. Police charged Jonah Smith, 47, of no fixed address, with burglary with a weapon and attempted malicious wounding.
He was homeless.
As opposed to, you know, benevolent wounding.
Yes. Well, there is such a thing. You know, surgery could be considered benevolent wounding.
Oh, God. But not by a homeless guy with a knife.
No. I would actually like to hear a defense attorney come up with that argument.
Surgery.
Yeah. It's I sensed a tumor. I was lunging to remove it.
Right.
You never know.
Next patient, Smoky Bob. We're here to excise the tumor. Dr. Pickle Gal, hand me the forceps.
We don't have forceps. We have these, like, coat hangers. Is that okay?
That'll do, Doctor. That'll do.
Wow. I mean, these stories are that goddamn near constant, you know? You just, people using firearms in self-defense, and all you ever hear, like, and not killing anybody. It's just millions of times per year. You check the FBI uniform crime stats, the amount of times that people reported to police that, yes, I pulled up my gun and the guy ran away. Yes, I pulled up my gun and the guy dropped his knife. Yes, I pulled up my gun and the guy stood there until the police arrived. Millions a year. Okay.
And then you get the occasional curveball, like, you know,
cat smack. The donation pop-up, Sam. You don't have the link, so you don't know when it's happening. But that's fine. Ebony Williams, thank you very much for the $8. Here is money. Merry Christmas. Well, thank you for the money, and a Merry Christmas to you, Ebony Williams. Glad you're here.
Christmas indeed.
Yeah. Now, this is a fun one. Hold on, I have to just... O.J. Simpson is finally free. Free at last! Free at last.
What do you mean? Was he arrested?
Repeatedly. Like, after the alleged murder of his wife and her alleged lover. Ron Goldman.
When he definitely killed them in Minecraft, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. He had been arrested multiple times after that. And went to jail for years. You didn't know that?
I did not know that.
Yeah.
No?
No.
Honestly, I don't really follow O.J. Simpson that deeply.
Oh, my mom did. Like, she could tell you every detail of, you know, oh, Jesus.
She also follows the Kennedys.
Yes. In excruciating detail. Yeah. Yeah. And what's the girl's name who had a baby daughter and then disappeared the daughter, allegedly?
Casey Anthony.
She followed that trial in excruciating detail. I had to hear all about it. It's like, Mom, I don't care. It's her child. It's like, yeah, I know, Mom, but just like, yeah. If he did it,
lots
exactly.
Of people killed their children.
I would take that as sort of like, you know, an implicit threat. Behave yourself, young Polly. It can happen.
It'll happen to you.
No, he was on parole, which has finally ended. So what happened is he had somebody had absconded with a bunch of his sports memorabilia, which is very valuable for a famous ball player, right? So like football cards, things he had signed, footballs and jerseys he had signed and stuff, all sorts of memorabilia, had absconded with it. And so he gets a couple of his friends and they go knock on the guy's hotel room in Vegas. And they're like, now...
See here, my good man.
No. Actually, that's what I'm laughing about. Nothing of the sort. Okay, because the guy was audio recording the whole thing. And what you just said in terms of, my good man, I think you have gone off with something, you know, materials that are not your own, and I would appreciate if you would return my property to me, good sir. It would be the exact opposite of what OJ did. If you listen to the audio, it's like, motherfucker, you think you can steal my shit, bitch? Like, and I'm not even kidding. Cusses at all. Like, when you hear OJ cuss, like, it's like he's like a friendly looking guy, unless you imagine him knifing his wife and Ron Goldman, of course. He comes across as a friendly guy. It's part of why he's so charming and why we saw him in all the Hertz ads in the 1970s commercials far. Because, you know, he's running and he's happy and yay.
Yeah. Yeah, he was jumping over luggage to, you know, run away from a murder scene, right?
That's right.
As well?
He wasn't...
Right?
He wasn't dumping the cap and gloves and knife in a fucking garbage or anything in an airport.
No.
Or handing him off to...
He was just really late.
Do you know who supposedly dumped, is suspected most strongly of supposedly dumping all the evidence?
Who?
Robert Kardashian. Kim Kardashian's father. The Robert
Bobby K.
Yeah. Robert Kardashian is a longtime good friend of O.J. Simpson, and that's why... That's why anybody knows who the hell the Kardashians are. That's how that name even got out there into the public, because of the celebrity around that celebrity trial. And later on, Kim Kardashian gets this idea of, like, I'm going to fuck this B-grade rapper on an obviously pre-recorded, edited sex tape that was terribly unerotic. If you ever watch it, it's just like, Jesus Christ. Jesus. Like, her acting is just... Like, talk about a dead fuck. If you want to know what a dead fuck is, go watch that. Sex tape.
I would rather not.
I've shoveled more lively ice cream.
Yeah. In any case, and that's what propelled her to fame and her younger sister to being a billionaire. Now, The only thing that was worthwhile in that O.J. Simpson HBO, I'm going to guess, special, I watched it. It was... There's one moment where Robert Kardashian, played by... I think it's Robert Kardashian. I'm not fucking that up. Mr. Kardashian is sitting... It goes to a restaurant with his daughters. And, like, you know, little Kimberly is one of them, right? With his four daughters. And... They go to a restaurant, everyone's kind of staring at him. And you know who plays him? David Schwimmer. The guy from Friends. Yeah.
Ross.
Ross from Friends, of all people, is who's playing him. And they're all staring at them, right? Because it's like, oh, you're Kardashian. You're that guy who, like, you know, helped OJ that night, and maybe you know what really happened, and so on and so forth. He's got this kind of celebrity thing. He's taking him out for Sunday brunch, and he sits down with all of them, and one of the little girls says, and you find out it's Kimberly, says, "Dad, why are they all staring at you?" It's like, it's because they've seen me on TV. But listen, girls, Kimberly, we're Kardashians, and we earn our way in this world. Celebrity means nothing. And I'm like, one of the writers of this show is such an asshole, and I love him for it. That was fucking golden. Kardashians work through their way in this world. Celebrity means nothing.
They work all right.
Mm-hmm. Working on back, Kimmy. Working on back.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Life is fine, OJ said, in an Associated Press interview back in 2019. Simpson saga makes him, in the words of his Las Vegas trial lawyers, one of the most famous people on the planet. Probably. He grew up in... I don't care. In a separate case more than a decade later, Simpson was convicted by a Las Vegas jury and sentenced to prison for leading five men, including two with guns, in a 2007 confrontation with two sports collectible dealers in a cramped hotel room off a Las Vegas casino hotel. Simpson insisted he only wanted to retrieve his personal mementos and items stolen from him following his acquittal in the double killings. He had been found liable for the deaths, right, blah, 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 blah. So they don't tell the story of it. Like, oh, man, that his sentence was subsequently reduced because the judge in that trial of, like, you know, goes in that room with some boys and it's like, I want my fucking shit back, bitches, you know, and two of them have guns. Simpson didn't have a gun. And he better thank the Lord above that he didn't bring a gun with him or take one of the guns that they had, that he let them be the gunman, because he would have gotten him, you know, a million fucking years. The judge threw the book at him and gave him the maximum sentence on every single thing he'd been charged with, and they charged him with fucking everything they could think of. And I'm not trying to, like, make a case for OJ being hard done by. It's just, when you look at the forced confinement, abduction, threats with a deadly weapon, intent to kill, like, on and on and on and on and on. Accessory to grand larceny with a weapon, like, anything. You got hit with like 16 different fucking charges and convicted on most of them, and the judge gave him the maximum sentence for every single fucking one of them. And then subsequently it was like, this is insane. Like, he has no previous record except for Minecraft yeeting two people. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So there you go.
All in Minecraft.
Yeah. It's too bad they don't tell that story, because it's actually really interesting. We should, in a future Noir Bar, we should look up that audio, because it is fucking hilarious to hear O.J. Simpson in a rage when he thinks he's talking to two thieves who've stolen from him, and he's there with three of his boys and two of them on her arm, so he's in gangster mode. It's hilarious to hear the juice talking. It's like all of a sudden he's hood as fuck. It's
anger juice. God. Anger juice.
Yeah.
Anger juice, I choose you.
National lottery scratch card fraud. Men jailed over £4 million jackpot claim.
Right, yeah, this is the one you came to me with, like, yeah, this happened. Like, wait, aren't those, like, all void because they were stolen?
Yeah. So here's the weird thing, Sam. Here's the story. Yeah. These two guys, John Watson of Bolton and Mark Goodman, Goodram, Mark Goodram, Jesus Christ.
Ugh. Is he friends?
You're right. I feel like I'd get along somehow.
fuck. All right, so Mark Goodram went to London to beg in 2019 and bought the winning card in Clapham. Clapham. They were found out when claiming the prize, as they had revealed they did not have a bank account despite using the debit card to buy the item. They had stolen the debit card, which they then used to buy a whole bunch of things. And it came along with some scratch and win tickets that they had bought. One of the scratch and win tickets was the £4 million prize. And they went to claim it. And because it was bought a debit card, it had to be credited to said account. And that's one of the ways you proved who you are. And no dice. And so, yeah, there you go.
Wow. Yeah, well done, guys.
Imagine serving 18 months for winning somebody else £4 million.
I mean,
right.
When
does the other guy even get the money?
What other guy?
The guy they stole the card from.
Oh, the guy who had the debit card? No. No lottery's going to pay out unless they absolutely have to. It's like an insurance company.
Yeah.
They're going to be like, you didn't buy the card, but it was bought with my card. That doesn't matter. That'd be like if somebody stole $20 from you and went and bought a bunch of scratch and wins. All of a sudden, you deserve the fucking money if they won? No. Why did these homeless guys go find a friend?
I don't know.
I would really put some serious thought to this, like some kind of way to make that work.
They should have cut the fucking owner of the debit card a deal. Like, look, man.
Right.
We stole your shit. Right? You stole your shit. But.
Yeah, hear me out now.
You take $2 million, we take $1 million each. Jesus.
Yeah, two win.
It's a win-win.
Like, are you kidding? Like, a £500 compensation that you'll probably never get paid because these two guys are homeless.
Yeah.
Aww.
And you send John Watson in to do it. And you leave the card with Mark Goodram, right? And then the actual ticket, I mean, with Mark Goodram. And you say, and the guy's going to be, you motherfucker, you stole my shit. You stole my card. You think I'm not going to call the cops on you? You could do that. But Mr. Goodram is in possession of the ticket. And he's in an undisclosed location. So, why don't we be reasonable? Why don't we, where do you work? Oh, what's that? You're a lorry driver? Why don't or whatever the fuck? You work in a fish and chip shop? How long is it going to take you to earn £2 million, man? Come on.
My client is willing to disclose.
Yeah. Mr. Goodram will resurface. If I were to call him at a payphone? I don't know. If I were to go knock on the dumpster he's currently residing in. Out back in the Tesco's.
If I start playing a tune with my shitty garbage, he will come running.
And Cabalistic Wizard's right.
Out of his dumpster.
What's a quid? I'm curious. Is that a quid? Are there any Brits in the audience? Is it?
It means a pound,
isn't it?
No, I get that. What's a quid is one of Drunkle's games on AAA. Yeah, because no one understands British slang, and so he attempts to mock us with it by creating a game that's entirely premised upon mocking us. Which is fine. It's fine.
For those who don't know, it doesn't just come from nowhere. A quid is a roll of leaves. That's why it's called a quid.
No, what I'm asking is, is this a British pound coin?
That's a £2 coin.
Is it?
Yeah, I believe
so. It's like the one time I said to Drunkle, it's like a sovereign. And he goes, a sovereign! And he went into his whole fucking thing about like how disgusted he was that nobody knows nothing. And I'm like, I don't know, man. I read a lot of Sherlock Holmes. And Holmes paid or had a bet with a guy over a sovereign. And I assumed that meant like a £5 note or something like that. I don't know. How am I supposed to know that fucking phrase went out of use?
It's a couple of guineas, I think.
Hey. You leave the Italians out of this. We got a story about them later, all right?
Oh, that's not ominous.
It never is with the Italians.
Not at all.
They're not molesters. They're just Italian. It's fine.
Come to me on the day of my daughter's wedding.
Yeah. Looks like a 2-pound coin. All right, fair enough. I like how it's got writing along the edge. I've never seen a coin like that before.
Oh, yeah. That's the term for it. It's to prevent people cutting metal off the outside of the coin.
Yeah.
This is
what, really?
Yeah. There was a huge thing years ago. Yeah, hundreds of years ago, of people taking minted coins and shaving metal off from them. Back when, you know, the coins actually have material value themselves because they're made of them precious. Yeah, people used to cut the metal off from her side, melt it down, and produce counterfeit.
Nice. Nice.
You learned two things today.
Yeah, what? Brazil nuts and counterfeit old style coins? Yeah.
Okay, so three things. Sorry, Polly, I kind of torpedoed your whole line of progression there. Please continue.
Did I have one of them? I don't think I did.
Allegedly.
No, I just said I like the writing along the edge. That was the end of it, man. Moving along. Okay. So the woman in a refrigerator. It finally happened. It's a true story. Okay, now.
In a refrigerator.
Yeah, woman in a refrigerator. Now, it's unfortunate that comic book curation is on, you know, basically permanently shelved, because Jack and Quiz would have laughed their ass off at this one. It's a comic skate thing. It's a comic book thing. The woman in a refrigerator became like sexism in comics because it's a long lore story where it's just like, oh my God, it happened. There's a woman in a refrigerator. But anyway, the story itself is funny in and of itself. A LaPorte woman who was eventually taken into custody Sunday, December 12th after allegedly hiding from police in a refrigerator. Now, does this look like a woman who would do such a thing?
Yes. Yes, this looks like the exact kind of woman that would do that.
Mm. Her hair isn't naturally that color. It's just really cold.
It starts shivering. I can't see it, but her hair is shivering from... We don't know how her hair gained sentient.
We dread to think.
But it did.
I don't believe her roots are sentient.
You don't?
No.
I think it's the only sentient part about her. I think she's been driven by her hair.
But this story's great, okay? Because she tried, and I will give her credit. She doesn't look that bright, but she tried. Okay, and I appreciate the effort. Okay, police say deputies went inside the residence to look for the 39-year-old Rebecca Rudd when they found bedding material that was made into a sheet rope. It was tied to a lightweight kitchen table and hanging outside the window, according to the report. Despite finding this, police continued to look inside the residence for Rudd, where they reportedly found her hiding in the refrigerator. See?
Oh, so she tried. Look, I climbed out the window, guys.
Yeah, go look for me elsewhere.
A cunning ruse.
Yes.
Yes.
So that's, see, that.
It's such a shame the table obviously could not support her weight, yeah, but you know. Whatever.
But she was probably limited in time, right? She had to move. She hears the sound, you know? It's like, oh shit, they're coming. What am I going to do? I can't run. I got nowhere to go. I got a stupid tattoo on my chest. I got purple hair. My roots are showing. I'm 39. I have no friends. I need meth. Like, so, but she managed in this state of, you know, chaotic anxiety over police hunting her to come up with this cunning ruse, as you said, this clever plan. Yeah. I'm gonna run some tracks off in the snow and then come back from a different direction, and they're gonna think I ran off into the woods. You know, at least you
die hard shit, isn't it?
Yeah. At least you tried. You know, most people will just hide.
I mean, yeah, you do have a point. You do have a point. At least she tried. Yeah, I have a little bit more respect for her now. Thank you, Polly.
I'd love to be the judge presiding over this. I really would. So, you tied the sheet rope to this lightweight table. Your Honor, I did not have time.
I was thinking on my feet.
Yeah.
I had limited time.
I am a dainty woman after all. Do not insult me by pretending that lightweight card table could not hold my weight. It certainly could. I weigh a slight 95 pounds. She totally
that's
doesn't.
When I'm dripping wet.
Yeah. No, she obviously doesn't. That's a big woman if you look at her. It's you can tell from the width of the shoulders. Is. Like, I mean, she could be a fucking linebacker.
Nice.
You have me, Williams, for $5 and some monies for far. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate the goat bondage.
And what was she ultimately arrested for? Well, she had been served with 3 different arrest warrants. That's why they were after her for misdemeanor charges, including battery, criminal mischief, and possession of paraphernalia. I'm assuming it was...
So she bought the meth pipes off of Wish.com.
Yes. I don't think it was... I think it was methaphernalia, personally.
Methaphernalia.
So to speak.
I like that.
Oh, look at this story. Isn't this great?
It's white.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's fantastic. It's my favorite one yet.
Hold on. There we go. Now, I brought this story up mostly because... Well... Look at that jawline.
What? Yeah.
I'm sorry. I just like laughing at human misery.
Her face. It just reminds me of someone I knew in high school. Like, they had the exact same proportion of face there. Just,
really? Well, people say that...
Yeah, she made up, like, a song of, like... Well, not even really made it up. It was just a SpongeBob theme, which, like, just replaced her face with, like, her face, square face.
Mm-hmm.
Or something like that. Like, just... Yeah, like, she made fun of it. She owned it. But just, like, yeah, that's...
You could lay bricks with that jawline. What the hell?
Yeah,
that's what I'm saying.
Like...
People say that Matt Damon has a square head. Like the joke goes on and on and on about Matt Damon's square head. Well, I mean, this woman. Let's talk about what a square head really looks like. Oh, I forgot to point out something here. We're going back. Australia mourns children killed in bouncy castle?
What
the fuck's going on, Far?
What? I don't know.
I mean, I'm not going to click on it because it's dead children, but like... In a bouncy castle? That's terrible.
And I want to know how it was.
Children,
like,
bouncy castle.
Of course,
yeah,
Far goes right
now.
To it. Like, I just I said I did want to.
Look, you mentioned the thing. I'm going to look up the thing.
All right.
Was it excessively rubberized? Were these children launched into low orbit? What are we talking here?
They had overinflated it. They were just launched.
No wonder I did not. No wonder I didn't understand this.
Why?
Did a really, really overweight guy jump on one end? What happened here? I must know!
What happened?
Okay, no.
It was underinflated and they jumped and just hit the ground?
No, they were all 5th and 6th graders.
Uh-huh.
Great. Who died after plunging about 30 feet from the bouncy castle. That was whipped into the air by a gust of wind. Thursday.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, that sucks. They were inside of a bouncy castle that fell to the ground and it didn't, like, you know...
Yeah.
Keep them alive? Like, you know?
Oh, that's a really shit bouncy castle.
That sucks.
Yeah.
That sucks.
And it's in Tasmania.
Oh, God, well, I think we all know what happened there.
Yeah,
I think we know where the wind came from.
Tasmania Police Commissioner Darren Hines said Friday that investigators will probe whether the bouncy castle was tethered to the ground. Yeah, what the fuck? That's my immediate thought of, like, were they, like...
The guy ropes and snapped, the children are flying away! Sorry, I'm a terrible human.
Because, like, usually... Yeah, it is fair to say the wind quite strong.
Thanks for the fucking critical update.
Shit. But, like, that yeah, that's my immediate thought, though, of, like, usually they tether that shit to the... What's going on in Tasmania?
Yeah. Lack of ballast, clearly.
Yeah, just... Nothing fit. Fuck.
So back to the... oh, no, we did this story.
Merry Christmas,
The semi-clever Methitarian. Right.
Methodist.
Yeah, Square Jaw McGee. why did I want to do this story again? What is it? Oh, yeah, she's just a fucking arsonist. Like, a fucking hardcore arsonist, this lady. Like, pyromaniac. A Maine woman was put on probation for a prior arson charge, has been accused of setting several fires. When police arrived, they saw... Is it really? Oh my god, it is! In Waterville!
The irony.
Good times. Okay. I'm sure they didn't find it funny, but when the police...
I love it when the planets align.
Yeah. When the police arrived, they saw several fires within the construction site of Colby College's Paul J. Schupps Art Center. So nothing of value was lost. All right. The Waterville Fire Department responded to put out the fire.
Sorry.
Fireville? And then an Earthville and Airville. You know, all the elements.
Police say that at least six fires had been intentionally set or attempted to be set at the construction site. Damage had been done to the construction material, dumpsters, and the actual building. That's right, y'all. There was a dumpster fire. Okay, she...
Oh, hell yeah. My favorite kind of fire.
And,
dumpster fire.
Miss Cubicle Carey was taken to the local hospital for medical treatment and then to the Kennebec County Jail. Well, at the hospital, police say Carrie, the cubicle one, assaulted one of the fire investigators and the Waterville police officer. I worked hard to set those fires. Carrie was charged with arson and two counts of assault on a police officer. According to police, Carrie was on probation because of a prior arson charge. Lady, what's the deal?
How many fires are you setting?
A lot. Like, how do you go before a judge and be like, Your Honor, I've learned my lesson, I'll never do it again? Like, you know what I mean? You're a recidivist arsonist.
Because you don't. You don't. You just don't. You just set fire to the court. Prove your point.
It's like, but, you know.
Waterville must burn.
Miss Carey, you set fire to the bench in the waiting room where you were.
Learned my lesson.
Yeah, I've learned my lesson from 5 minutes ago. I swear to you, Your Honor.
You're setting fire to the legal documents right now on the desk. And I've learned my lesson too.
Just looking around as you're just fine, Your Honor. Fine.
Yeah.
Oh, I love this title. Schools across U.S. respond to vague shooting threats circulating on TikTok. Oh.
Oh.
Great, thanks
TikTok.
Yeah, thanks. Coordinating the information. Oh, there's more information about the Waterville police. This is great.
Oh, is that
the Waterville police make largest drug bust in city's history by man? Okay. Waterville police say they've made they seized more than $780,000 worth of fentanyl and cocaine. Waterville's a happening place.
Mm-hmm.
They've got meth, maybe they've got fentanyl, they've got cocaine, and they've got square jaws and fires. Police arrested 37-year-old Victor Nicholas Santos Sanchez of the Dominican Republic, who they say was in the U.S. illegally. What?
Victor Nicolas Soto Sanchez of the Dominican Republic. Fuck off.
What, you don't buy that?
That's just the combination of names. Just... it's all over the place. All over the place.
He was charged with aggravated trafficking. That's right. He'd sell you drugs, but only when in a really bad mood. It would...
Buy my shit, you fucker.
Aggravated trafficking.
Okay. Yeah, he really just wanted to push those drugs, man.
You're gonna buy these, fucker! You know, it's just...
What if it was just sounds like a fantastic town, doesn't it?
What state is this in? We've been talking about this place for a minute. Where the fuck?
Yeah, where is it? Yeah, where is it?
WGME, which is
Maine?
This is in Maine?
Ohio? No, this like I'm seeing a couple of them.
Maine. I'm pretty sure Maine.
Maine or Ohio? Which one is this?
Oh, this looks like Maine. Like, sign up for our daily newsletter, and this is Maine as fuck. Maine is actually a beautiful state,
I mean,
except...
I don't
Maine is a fantastic state.
Ohio.
You know, except for the,
no, it can't be Ohio,
because Dominican...
Waterville.org here is saying, the safest city in Ohio.
Far. do you know what Ohio doesn't have?
Square-faced arsonists?
No, they could. They could. Beaches and lighthouses.
Well, I don't know American...
that's okay, Far. Neither do Americans.
Yeah, well... Yeah, he's not wrong. He's not wrong.
For example, if you want to about living proof of that, there's a lighthouse in Utah.
Why?
Ask Utahns. I don't know. I don't know. I never got a straight answer.
Ask Utahns? Yeah. Is that what they're called?
Yeah.
They're not Utoshians?
No.
Utahians.
About Waterville. I want to know about Waterville. Tell me, government of Waterville.
Waterville police. Well, let's hear. See, they're actively searching for. Okay, so apparently the DR is not sending its best. He was charged with aggravated trafficking and scheduled drugs, being a fugitive from justice, and for outstanding warrants in two other states. But because he's in the country illegally, he was immediately released, given $1,700 by the Department of Homeland Security, and trafficked to the nearest swing state. Excellent. I added all that last part. Santo Sanchez was arrested on Tuesday following a three-week investigation that started after police received reports about a man who was allegedly selling fentanyl and cocaine out of an apartment on College Avenue. Oh, my God. Police say when they searched the apartment, Soto Sanchez was staying in and found about 6 pounds of fentanyl. That's a fuck ton of fentanyl. Six fucking pounds.
Hell.
And another 5 pounds of blow, as well as 4 handguns, 2 shotguns, and $6,000 in cash. Fuck, he wasn't screwing around. Jesus fuck.
Christ, that's enough fentanyl to render the fucking elephants extinct. That's a lot
of
fentanyl.
Holy fuck. Wikipedia snippet says, he's in Maine and sells duck dog. Maine's an underrated state, by opinion. It's one of the places I'd consider moving. Along with Texas, Arizona, Nevada, Florida, Georgia. That's about it.
No, I went.
So you want to move to Waterville then?
That's
what I'm hearing.
If you're going to Maine, it's either Waterville or Portland. Those are the happening places. I would have said just Portland before tonight, but clearly Waterville, because I mean, you can go down to College Ave and pick up all the fentanyl and blow you need.
And it's also a very historical place, according to that website.
Wikipedia snippet says Dirty Sanchez. Well done.
Dirty Sanchez.
Yeah. So he's
that
being...
That does sound like a fucking gangster, doesn't it? Soto Sanchez.
Yes, it does. Yeah. According to the Morning Sentinel, Soto Sanchez entered the country in 2014, and he has 2 outstanding warrants, one from New Jersey in 2020 for burglary and assault, and the other from Massachusetts in 2014 for possession of cocaine with intent to distribute. And of course, they did deport him, because why would you have deported him? Why would you ever have deported this brilliant
upstanding
man?
Young man.
Yes, this you know, golden export from the Dominican Republic. I mean, how much society has gained from the presence of this man?
He's just a low cost, right? Backstreet fucking pharmacologist, clearly.
I feel like we have a theme going on with this, Baba, of backstreet dealers.
You know, and I mean, he is almost certain to not reoffend. I mean, his very presence is a crime, but he's certainly not likely to reoffend. I mean, goddamn white supremacist fucking justice system.
He has learnt from his mistakes. Just like the arsonist learnt as she's setting fire to her court documents in front of the judge.
I like how that is now canon.
It's canon to me, because I find it hilarious.
Oh, I don't disagree. I don't disagree.
Yeah, okay, well, there's a thing.
Now I choose to see the situation.
Demon Man says, dude is IRL Tony Montana. Tony Montana had a green card. He was in the country legally. I mean, he shouldn't have had a green card, don't get me wrong. But, I mean, that was the thing, right? The so-called Cuban crime wave that was going on in the early 80s where Fidel Castro opened up his prisons and pushed them all off the island, and then was like, you know, yeah, go to America, and they arrived in, like, flooding amounts, and of course, they were all criminals, and they all lied about having no criminal record. The Castro regime released none of their records because it just wanted to empty their prisons. You guys deal with them. And it's pretty clever, bastard move. Yeah, and Tony Montana being one of those guys, they ended up getting all green cards in the movie. Yeah. You've seen Scarface, right, Sam?
Yeah.
Okay, good. I'm not gonna ask if Far has. I think I know the answer.
Yeah, the answer is.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. What's up next? What dastardly criminal do we have for us next?
Well, she's not a dastardly criminal, but she is a miserable bitch. I refuse to use my boss's real name in the office. It's all about respect.
Uh huh.
One woman asked for advice online after she was reported to HR for not calling people by their correct names, and people were divided, with some arguing she was right. Do you want just the TLDR of this? So this woman's name is Samantha. She wants to be called Samantha. Some people around the office called her Sam or Sammy. Okay? Her boss called her Sam, and a couple of times she said, please don't call me that. I prefer Samantha. He called her Sam a couple more times after that. Right? So she goes to Reddit and complains about this. Now, this her boss's name is Richard. So she starts incessantly calling him Dick.
Bad life.
And goes to Reddit to complain about this.
Not so fair play.
So there's the full story.
I mean, like, she asked. She did ask.
She did.
To be fair, like, no, don't call me that. I don't know why she had to involve Reddit, of all things, though.
Because she's a modern woman in a liberal Western society.
Ah, sorry. I see. I see.
Hold on, I'll put my misogyny back in the box for a moment. Absolutely, you know, it's absolutely fair for her to turn around and start calling her boss, who is named Richard, Dick. That's fair enough, because he kind of is.
Well, we're assuming that he didn't do so mistakenly. Now, if he was like Sam, like to assert his authority over her, like to be like, I'll call you whatever the fuck I want, then yes. If he just, I don't know, whatever the fuck. Didn't even fucking remember. Like, you're lucky I remember your name. I don't remember half the people's names in the office. You're Sam because it's short and I remember it. You know, maybe that was the whole thing. And if she comes back at him with a, Dick, I had a question for you, Dick. How would you like these papers organized, Dick? Like, you know, then it's not really fair play, is it? Like, I mean, circumstances are important here.
I think it kind of is fair play. If she's asked him to call her Samantha, if she has asked him to do so, if she has one of those fucking name tag kind of bullshits like they do in the really big office company type things,
uh-huh.
You know, clear indication. And he, you know, even if it is an accidental thing that he's calling her Sam,
uh-huh. You know,
for her to go, okay, Dick, it kind of helps build up that sort of, you know, memory sort of situation. Ah, yeah, this is the chick that calls me Dick because she doesn't want to be called Sam, so I'll call her Samantha. You know, that sort of thing. Conditioning. Women do that. Women do a lot of that. And it's fine.
Now,
yeah,
I think the main thing that I want to point out is just how shitty the mirror is. Which I'm told often.
Yeah.
But, like, I mean, I don't think people realize just how shitty the mirror is. Like, this is written by Rosaline Fenton, an audience writer. They're actually farming articles from their own fucking audience.
I mean, how's that?
I mean, I'm the one that sent this to you, right?
Like,
I remember, like, just seeing the title and just being like, yeah, here you go.
Okay.
Like, I didn't even really read that much into it. It was like, hey, here's something, I guess.
Hey,
I didn't even catch that it was an audience writer.
Yeah.
Holy shit, man.
Like that's...
How do you think I went down to this job?
That is weak as fuck. Like, mirror, you are... Like, you can't even get staff writers where you piecemeal shit out to them for low pay, because writing pays shit now, unless you're a senior level news entertainer, newsreader type. Like, if you're just writing articles for...
Holly.
Yes?
That's some BuzzFeed shit, though. That's what they do. They just go, hey, yeah, you're one of our, audience members. Here, you make something. And that's how you get shit like, Make a cupcake and you'll see what fucking astrology sign your partner will be.
Yes.
That's how you get that shit.
Yeah, no, I hear
it's
you.
The exact same way.
Oh, you mean the plate.
But
the root.
Yeah.
Yeah, that too.
Yeah, fuck the root, Jesus Christ. A news website supposedly about the African American experience, written by a bunch of blog writers, because every article is written like a blog article. It's just someone's opinion on something that may have happened. Yeah, blog journalist, something that may have happened recently or 4 years ago. It doesn't fucking matter. If you read the root, it's just like, Jesus Christ, this is just a blog. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Ebony Williams asked the same question twice correctly. I understand why she's upset, but again, why Reddit? Why Reddit? You get Reddit better than I do. What is it with people going to Reddit to complain?
I was asking the same thing this entire time. Like, why Reddit?
Well,
why Reddit?
But you go to Reddit. You understand Reddit. I don't get it. Like, why do people go...
I don't really most of the time anymore, but it's like... Like, here's the thing with Reddit stories. 90% of them are made up. Like, okay, good chunk of these stories are made up. But then you have shit like this where, look, it might be legit.
Mm-hmm.
I think it speaks to the broader question of not just why Reddit, but Reddit. How long? Why?
Yeah, that too. But there are some subreddits where it's like, this is actually a useful thing. Thank you for existing. But then there's just shit like this where it's like... I'm fairly certain, like, this is probably posted in Am I the Asshole? Like, it has to be from
probably.
And it's okay.
I like r/totally legal software acquisition. That's one of my very, very informative, very helpful.
I've never heard of that one.
Ah.
I'll find the right button eventually here, chat. There we go. I just wanted to embiggenate the screen ever so slightly in this. Left click shift plus the fucking apostrophe button. That's what does it. Anyway.
Don't even talk to me about arcane keyboard shortcuts, Polly. I'm using a Mac right now.
The command key. It's so powerful. Let's see what else the mirror has to offer. Oh, yes. This was a great one. Company apologizes after deliberately leaving chocolate out of an advent calendar. Would you care to guess, Sam? Why? That? I want you to see it early. Why they left chocolate out of the advent calendar? Deliberately.
So that you would come into the store that they own and... I don't
know. You live in 2021, Sam. That's the best hint I'm going to give you. You live in 2021. It is current year. Why would they leave chocolate out of the advent calendar?
Oh, hey, DLC.
Because
you must pay us extra money.
It's a DLC. Didn't expect that answer, but okay, you get credit for that. Okay. I just want to see if anyone could guess, because I guessed right away. I was like, nah, you know what it's probably going to be? And then you find out you're right, and you're like, fuck, I was right. You know, you ever been there?
Because
yeah,
chocolate
when you're right.
Is offensive to some people.
Close. You're in the parking lot behind the ballpark on it.
Because some people might be allergic and they don't want to get sued.
No, it's to highlight inequality, Sam.
Oh, so it's because it's brown. Okay, right.
They left out one day's chocolate, so when the kid opens it, there's no chocolate in there, and they're like, oh.
Wait, this is for kids?
Yeah.
This is for kids?
Of course.
Oh, fuck them. Fuck you.
And so children know what it's like to not have. Because they expect to get a chocolate treat on that day, and there's nothing for them, and that's what it's like to be poor. And that's why capitalism sucks.
Hold on. Real quick. The kids that would be, you know, the quote-unquote target audience for this kind of thing probably have enough money to simply go out and buy more chocolate. The kids don't have the money to go out and buy more fucking chocolate and get the shitty advent calendar are the ones that are actually going to lose out from this. Well done, Tonys. You cunt.
They really did highlight inequality there, though, didn't they?
Yeah.
By creating more of it.
Okay. Yeah. Dr. Functional asks, what's an advent calendar? Advent is the season obviously running up before Christmas, right? That's the religious name for it. And the idea being is that, like, okay, so there's a bunch of old school, like, it's like a cardboard sheet, the modern ones, right? That with perforated doors. And it names off each of the days, like the 1st of December, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, you get the idea. And each day you tear it open sort of as a countdown thing. You open that little perforated door and there's a little chocolate treat back there. And they usually come in the form of bells and sleighs and Christmas trees and things like that, like the little chocolate pieces.
They usually are really shit.
And they are far as not wrong.
Yeah, I had a couple as a kid. They're just crappy chocolate.
Yeah, and then the December 25th one is usually a big, big door, and the biggest chocolate is behind that one. Now, the traditional ones are super cool.
Oh, I didn't
even
get that.
No,
like, it was just the same size doors, all the doors.
Really?
I was gonna... The advent calendars I had growing up, they never had a 25th door. Ever.
Really?
They didn't?
No, because that's Christmas Day. You know, that's when you get your other gift.
I guess so, yeah. I mean, that makes sense. I think they had, like, the 25th on ones here. It's just they're tiny. Like, they're the same size. So it's not as if you're like, oh, I get the big treat on Christmas. No, it's the same as every other day. Fuck you.
Yeah, well, these are all like... Okay, there. There's a good example of a shit one. Okay?
Yes.
Yeah, that one, yeah.
Okay, see? All little square doors cut out like so, or perforated out like that, and you tear it open, there's a little chocolate treat behind there. And, oh, look, it's all over the place, so the kids got to search.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just looking to see if there's
usually how they are, though.
Is there a 25?
Is this is this 25?
Isn't
like it? The big old block?
I don't suppose.
Maybe.
It's supposed to be like a fun way for kids to count down Christmas and stuff. Now, these are shit. Like, the classic ones back in the day. Like, Victorian.
But the classic ones didn't used to have chocolates in at all, did they? It was little toys and stuff.
Well, they're cool like this. Like, they have actual doors. Like, it's like a physical object. You see what I mean?
Oh, those are chocolate coins, though.
Yeah, and this is a very cool one. So each day you open a door and whatever. Like that's a cool one. Some of them have like little, like the. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are just like a one-sided door, and then the 25th is like, excuse me, when you get to the bottom of the house, you open the double doors, and there'll either be a big chocolate in there, or it says Merry Christmas behind there. Like, those are the really traditional ones. This is a modern one that's been done in a cool way. I like the cutout of the deer and the whatnot. But, yeah, anyway, so that's what an advent calendar is. You've never heard of one. And so this company that's been making them for fucking years decided to get all politically correct with it, Tony's chocolate noni countdown calendar. And you'd open each door and find a festive picture. There was no chocolate, beer, makeup, or procedure. But considering the misery and gloom of the last 2 years, many of us have indulged in a treat-based advent calendar. And who doesn't love a little chocolate each morning? Especially when you're young and normally have strict limits on chocolate consumption. But one chocolate firm has apologized after leaving some children in a flood of tears after they discovered there was no sweet treat behind a window. Parents who bought their kids the advent calendar from Tony Chocolate whatever contacted the company who confirmed they left out a chocolate on purpose. The Fair Trade Company left out December 8th as part of a bid to educate consumers about inequality in the chocolate industry.
Okay, if you're buying Fair Trade products, they're already more expensive. You're already making a conscientious decision, okay, to purchase more equal products, right?
Oh God, look, the story just gets worse. Okay, first of all, you did it on December 8th, the Feast of the Immaculate Conception. Fuck you! It's a special day and you had to do it on December 8th, but all right, moving on. This was then followed up by two chocolates on December 9th in a bid to highlight the imbalance. But it was hard for some children to understand. And one mom, writing on her Facebook page, my 8-year-old daughter was in floods of tears at the disappointment. She has ADHD and is awaiting a possible autism diagnosis. So what seems like a small upset to others is a big deal to her. I mean, it just keeps getting worse. Jesus Christ.
Oh, God.
You said
okay, usually those two diagnoses go hand in hand, so I wouldn't be surprised just hearing that reaction, but, like, holy fuck.
What goes hand in hand? With it?
ADHD and autism.
Oh.
Like, there's a... Yeah.
I thought you were going to say chocolate consumption. I was like, really? Okay.
Well, yeah, no, that too, actually, ADHD and chocolate consumption. It's part of the self-medication. No, seriously, it is. It's like part of the self-medication thing, right? Of like, I've got to get the sugar in me, or like, whatever the fuck.
Okay, no,
you know, to wake the fuck up.
No, copycat. I completely agree with you. Good luck getting repeat customers. Yeah, I hope this fucks your business in the way the capitalistic open free market system works. You piss off a bunch of your customers. Well, fuck you.
Fuck you, Tony!
Hey, Tony, what the fuck, huh? What the...
Are you doing the hand gestures, Polly? You have to do that.
I was, actually. I was doing the double hand gestures at the time. I swear to you, I was.
Good man.
Now, what you might notice is that this article was written by Rosalind Fenton, audience writer. Same as the
it's the same person.
Yes.
She's a busy woman, Rosalie. Yeah.
Did she write the next one too? No, a different audience writer did.
But it's also an audience writer.
Horrified woman shares skin-crawling reason her mom's dishwasher broke down. Now, I ask you, Far,
don't ask
Sam,
me.
Audience,
yes.
Don't ask me.
Friendly bar patrons, I ask you, is this woman with her posed selfie picture, who's on Instagram, by the way, and TikTok. Okay, I'm just saying, on Instagram and TikTok, hold that in your mind. You know, is she just looking for a little self promotion here, possibly? You tell me. Okay?
Possibly.
A woman on TikTok was horrified when she removed the back of her mom's dishwasher to find out why it had stopped working, and what she found will make your skin crawl. Okay. Household appliances can seemingly break down for no good reason rather than paying a specialist to come and fix the issue, and sometimes having a look at it can cause the fires and damage yourself. But one woman on TikTok vowed she would never investigate the causes of a problem herself again after she stumbled across something horrific in the back of her mom's dishwasher. Trinity Kirkland, who posts under Trinity Kirkland, posted a video of herself on her boyfriend removing the back of the dishwasher to have a look inside, and the pair were shocked by what they saw. Fucking get to the fucking point! At least three rats scurrying around inside the appliance.
Skin crawling. Look, it would have been more gross if they were dead.
Yes, it would have been. And there are said rats. My boyfriend came home while my mom's dishwasher found out why my mom's dishwasher wasn't working.
Trinity of rats, if you will.
Yes. One person wrote, I would actually drop dead right then and there if I saw this. One person wrote. Well, another person wrote, it's one of my missions tonight to get you guys to understand just how shitty the mirror is. Like, it's not so much the story, it's the medium that I'm mocking. You guys have nothing to talk about. You have no journalists whatsoever. You're just getting your audience members to go to Reddit and TikTok and write them up as stories.
You mean like The Guardian, The Telegraph,
or CNN simply saying, as reported in the New York Times, yes, it's the same thing just happening.
At
yeah.
But they're authoritative news sources.
Yes, they are.
Sources.
Yes, they don't.
Sources. I'm going with that. Sources.
Sources. Get your sources.
Oh, Molly O'Cammy's here. Hey, Polly W. sound a lot better. Glad to hear it. I'm glad you are here as well. It was an extremely rough Friday. I don't know if I'm going to get into the details tomorrow on Sinatra Show. I'm not sure anybody wants to hear them, but it was a long, shitty family drama day, medical things, and just it went on and on and on and on and on. And I left my phone and driver's license and billfold at home, so I was driving around illegally. I mean, small crime, right? If you actually
nice.
I
mean,
I don't even know in my state what the fine. I'm hoping it's just a fine would be. Like, you have a valid driver's license, right? They look up your name and it's like, yeah, you got a valid driver's license, you just don't have it on you. It's, I'm hoping that's not jail time. Maybe it is. Maybe they need money. I don't know.
Slap on the wrist. It's like a fucking traffic violation, really.
Well, I would like to think it's not a criminal one. Moving along.
That'd be a weird criminal offense.
Oh god, but that's a fucking Jesus.
Yeah.
Oh, the politically correct is a very much not.
Far was right. I should have kept this for now. It's the world's problem. Now it's everyone's problem.
Yeah. Now it's everyone's problem. Well, you can reuse it.
Now I can.
Everyone's problem.
Where's the bigger one? Show me the bigger one. Because you get to see, like, the whole body. It's even
worse.
Invigorate. Enlarge and enhance, Polly.
Right.
Enhance that, Ronald.
There he is. Go away, mirror bullshit.
It fucking just completes it.
Go away, mirror thing. I don't want to... There it is. Okay.
That is horrifying.
It really is, isn't it? Like, wow, but you can't look away.
Yes, now we know the carpet doesn't match.
No.
I was kind of assuming there was a French fries.
I mean, why does he have knee-high socks on? That's the point.
I mean,
that's your concern.
Isn't that what he has on, like, underneath the clothes anyway?
Yeah, absolutely. Underneath his baggy pants, you see, like, his pants ride high, and you see
you see him, right?
Yeah, his striped socks. As far as I can remember, yeah.
Not wearing any of the clothes apart from the banana hammock. So, what's the point?
At least they gave him a healthy bulge.
I think that might be just a pouch full of grease from the fries, to be honest.
Yeah, or that's where he's keeping the nuggets. See, I'm glad Sam's here, because Far wouldn't have laughed at that. That's good.
I've been outplayed by a cartoon otter. This is my life now. It's all fucking downhill.
It peaked with Ronald McDonald there.
Oh, yeah. People warned to keep an eye out for walnut-sized lumps on their Christmas trees. Okay, what are the walnut-sized lumps, guys? Any guesses?
Cancer.
Are they cancer?
The missing chocolates from those advent calendars.
That's where they kept them. You gotta search the tree and deal with the prickly's to highlight inequity.
Yeah.
Wasp nest, gotta be.
A wasp's nest, not bad. Not bad. Now, this is written by Courtney Poochin, senior audience writer.
Senior audience writer. I see.
As in they don't pay her because she collects a pension, or what?
Yes.
There they are. There is the walnut-sized lump.
Oh, it's walnut-shaped as well.
Yes. It's a praying mantis egg, and there's 100 to 200 praying manti, whatever, in there.
Whoa.
That's
kind
of cool. Tell you what.
Uh-huh.
Don't just throw those away. Don't burn them. Send them to me. I'll get a fish tank set up or something. Not put in the water. I want to raise some praying manti.
And experts have said the temperature inside our homes could speed up the time it takes to hatch the eggs, meaning your living room could be crawling with bugs first because they think it's spring, so they, like, you know, come out.
Mantis is a cool one.
So, praying mantis is, like, put these on like pine trees?
If
is that just a thing?
I didn't think so, but I was reading, and this is happening like in one of them weirdo Nordic countries. Norwegian trees. Yeah, so in Norway, it's mostly happening. But some of those trees were shipped to Springfield, Virginia, and it happened in 2019 from a Norway spruce.
So these are like
imported
Nordic
from
Nordic praying mantises.
Yeah.
Huh.
So they come out screaming a Loch Lake bar, you know. Yeah.
Oh, great. Thanks, Polly.
I'd like to thank everybody for joining us here at the Noir Bar.
This
is a great final show.
You reminded me of something. You reminded me of something, Sam. It's time for Polly to complain. I am like, you know, people said, you know, Polly rants, whatever. I end up being embarrassed after I've done them because I realize I just like went off on like flew off the handle over something. I could have just, you know, I don't enjoy them as much as people think I do. It's or like I'm itching to do.
We don't care about that. We enjoy them.
Well, this is what I mean. People, that's what Weibo said to me. She's like, Polly, you just like, I'm like, no, I'm not fucking chomping at the bit with an itchy trigger finger, just getting ready to find something to yell at. Usually it's just when I'm impassioned over a given subject that I just start blah, 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 blah. And then 2 minutes later, I realize, holy shit, man, you've been yelling for like 2 fucking minutes. Maybe it's time to stop. You know? So I don't know. In any case, here's something that I am legitimately angry about. And
all right,
it's disappointment. It's dismay. It's offense. It's
disapproval.
I definitely disapprove. I feel violated, victimized even a little. Do you want to know? Look at this.
Okay.
Look at this.
Oh, yeah, this.
Whoa.
You see this shit? They even got Stooley. Motherfuckers.
They did. They did steal Stooley.
All right, I'm calling up the lawyers.
I don't see it. Well, lawyers are those guys that OJ brought. Somebody. Dudes with guns, you know? Maybe bring that arson lady from Maine to take care of their fucking bar? I don't know, something. But I'm pissed. This is bullshit. And you know the most offensive thing of all? Like, as if this wasn't bad enough, right? You scroll down. In my recommends, is there a single recommend for like, oh, there's Monkey recommended. Are there any Noir bars recommended? No, not a one. Nary a one. Motherfuckers.
Maybe.
Rude. It's wrong. They're trampling on your turf, Polly. Trampling on your turf. Okay. We need to have a council of the dawn. This is not acceptable.
To go so far as to even steal Stooley, like your boy Pat says, was up at. It's just.
I got a recommendation.
You did?
Yeah. I went to it and I got one. And it's the one that's currently airing.
It'll be a personalized recommendation because, you know, you watch Polly stuff. Shout out to all the people out there that watch Polly stuff.
True.
We appreciate it.
Yeah, he does appreciate it. I just am so disappointed by this. You have no idea. Fucking thieves, man. Get your own shit. Come up with your own ideas, you lazy bastards.
Boom jazz. Is it like jazz music synchronized with the production of demons?
You know, Zelthor asked that very same question last night. He was confused by doom jazz. He's like, really, doom jazz? What the fuck is that? It's a sub genre of jazz. It's electronic, synthetic, or synthesized, rather, I should say. Jazz that's minimalistic, low tempo, lot of bass. So it's just, so it's barely qualifies as jazz, but it's music to slit your wrists to.
Oh, right up my alley.
Yeah, I don't know if you'd like it, though, because it's... The way that it's done, it's not done like cool, like lo-fi hip-hop or anything like that. It
You know, it sounds like a whole bunch of MIDI instruments, you know? It sounds fake, you understand what I'm saying? Not like lo-fi hip-hop where it's meant to sound low fidelity on purpose, deliberately, so it's got like record crackles in it, like vinyl record crackles and scratches and whatnot, and it's all part of the vibe of it, if you will. Drum kicks, break beats and shit. I like lo-fi. The doom jazz is just a little too dark for me. It's all like that.
It's like doom, as in the classic first-person shooter doom kind of sound. Synthesizer, six instrument.
Yeah, I think it's a little better than 16-bit though, but not by much.
Is it? I'll dig some out later. Once I've sterilized my favorite razor blade. In Minecraft.
So yeah.
In Minecraft.
Yeah.
All in Minecraft.
Oh, here's a fun one.
This one.
Nan blasted for buying grandkids matching PJs, except for son's stepchild.
Spicy, man.
I just want to know how it got to the point of, like, you've got the kids lining up for a picture. Did your parents say, like, anything here? You know? Did they go a little bit like, this is a little fucked up?
Real quick, this is brought to us by the emeritable hand of Paige Holland, showbiz audience writer.
Uh-huh. Showbiz audience writer.
Right.
My favorite.
Yeah. Thank you, Paige Holland. Showbiz audience writer. Jesus Christ, Mirror. I
just typing this shit up. Da, 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 da.
I mean, that's rough. A woman who didn't give her son's stepchild pajamas to match the rest of her other grandchildren has been slammed online for people saying she's dead wrong. I mean, based. I don't know if it's bass, man. It just sounds fucking cold as fuck.
Yeah, like, this sounds mean. For no other reason than fuck you, I guess.
Yeah. I mean, that. If anyone ever asks you, like, what's the most passive-aggressive thing you've ever heard, you now have a story to tell.
Oh, God, right?
Like, you would have been better off to slap the kid across the face saying you're not part of this family. Like, you know what I mean?
Me is the love hearts being censored.
Yeah, that's a little weird.
Yeah.
That is a little weird.
So you already got hearts over their faces. Why did you pixelate them too?
There's some redundancy with their redundancy.
Yeah.
I just don't, like, also, like, to get back to, like, how they took this picture. Like, okay, so you took a picture of the kids lining up. Why did you include the stepchild in this photo at all?
Oh, because that would be the dad, I would imagine.
But that still gets into the whole, like, okay, how did you allow this to happen? Because it's so obvious that this is just like, fuck this kid in particular.
Makes me laugh. Just scroll back up to the picture there, real quick, Polly.
Uh huh.
There's one real child on the left there that's not included. In the picture. They've been, like, mostly cut off in the image.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it could be a much larger picture that they just squeezed into their little 6x9 space here.
I like to imagine that this picture has actually been taken by the new girlfriend, whose son that is. And it's a passive aggressive response. Like, oh, no PJs for my son, huh? Well, we're gonna cut this grandchild off then.
Yeah.
Yeah, you like that, right. Bitch.
That's the one who won't kiss his grandmother. Fuck him. It's now, Far, you had mentioned earlier about BuzzFeed.
Bitch.
You talked about BuzzFeed being...
Yes.
Now,
yes.
Now, they're farming articles from their audience, you said. Now, I ask you.
Yeah, yep.
Just write a fan fiction. We'll actually guess what your love language is. Now, I ask you. Is this crowdfunded crap? I mean, this is clearly high quality material. remember BuzzFeed, the people who released the Steele dossier?
This is written by a BuzzFeed staff, so wow.
Right, but
wow.
At BuzzFeed, staff is their alternate term for unpaid intern. You know, it's like.
Yeah, have a point.
So would you like to know what your love language is? A little sprinkle of yangst, some yearning. Yeah, did I say yangst?
Yeah, you did. Is that Yankee angst?
Is it the past form of yank? I yanked my dick last night. Like it was.
I took it as like, you know, a fan fiction term, right? It's like it's Yankee angst.
Oh, I get it. It's like YA fiction, yeah, angst. So it's yangst. Okay. Yeah.
I took it to be the past tense of former Democratic candidate Andrew Yang.
Jesus, man.
I'm yearning. I love to bring it about. Jesus. Okay, what's our language of love, Polly?
Wow, who cares? Do you have to write a fan fiction first? Have you done that, Sam?
Maybe.
It's a first for us.
Okay, have you written a fan fiction that isn't full of erotic BDSM, etc. stuff?
I played the fifth.
Okay, well, being not in America, that is not a privilege right that you are allowed to assert.
I'll have you know I'm still eligible.
We are now going to put Far to the test.
Great.
It's smoking great. Hot. It's the middle of summer down there.
Looking forward to this.
Winter Wonderland and so forth.
It's not that hot right now.
Oh, that's good.
Which is surprising.
That's good. Okay, so
yeah,
this...
But I'm just waiting for it, you know?
So here we go. Here in Australia, we don't deck the halls with boughs of holly. We're more likely to deck the garden sheds with something else. According to the song, what do we use? Redback spiders, boughs of wattle, empty tinnies, or plastic reindeer?
I have no fucking idea.
What is a wattle for?
It comes off a tree, I'm pretty sure.
Branches.
What's a tinny? Tin can?
Yeah,
I think that'd be a tin can.
Okay.
A tinny is a kind of beer.
Oh, oh, oh.
Oh, like is it a flower?
An empty beer can.
It's a Scottish tin.
Well, Far as our resident Aussie, so it's up to her.
Yeah, well, I don't know. Like, this.
Fuck. Molly says I'd send my fan fiction, but I'd be suggesting a lot of furry crap. Really?
Great.
Great. Yeah.
Why don't you just put wattle? That seems to be plant like.
A fair guess.
Know.
Yeah, no, I hear you. Okay.
I mean, it's better than redback spiders. Like, fucking, like, what are you. You hanging up redback spiders? What are you wanting to die?
Well,
are you fucking kidding me? Those are poisonous.
Well, they're saying
it's
according
fuck.
To the song. I don't even know what fucking song they're talking about. The only Australian Christmas
song
I
know
is the
Five Boomers?
The Six White Boomers, which is a great song. It just it is. I love
it's
that song.
Shame the guy that wrote it is a degenerate.
Oh fuck, is he?
But you know, whatever. Yeah, he's a.
Oh fucking Far. How many other fucking things are you gonna ruin? Oh, fucking Judy Garland killed herself. The guy who wrote this song fucks children. Like, what is it with you? I just.
Polly, it wouldn't be a Christmas in Noir Bar if I didn't ruin something for you, I guess. So it's just a yearly tradition now. I've accepted it.
I swear you just.
It's an upside down land, Polly.
Every time I say I like something, I swear Far just goes searching for, you know, things to ruin it. It's just. Dashing through the bush in a rusty Holden ute. Picking up the dust, Esky in the boot.
Oh.
From Aussie Jingle Bells.
Okay.
If you manage to have a Captain Cook in your Aussie Esky, what are you most likely to find?
Captain Cook? I don't fucking know.
Cold tinnies of the amber fluid.
Yeah, why do they keep...
I don't know.
beer cans?
They come in tins.
Oh, hey, Druggle, what's going on?
I hope I'm not to. Obviously, I'm still invited into the Discord. I saw you were doing it.
Yes.
I hope I'm not intruding. Let me know if I'm not, mate.
You are not.
If I am,
we are currently giving.
On. Am I? Am I not? Or am I?
You're fine.
Tell me what's going on.
She's currently in the middle of an Australian Christmas quiz.
Well, whatever she says is going to be upside down, mate. Polly, how's it going? It's be called tinnies, mate, because it's be called tinnies because they are in tins.
Thanks, Drunkle. That was very informative.
Okay. Have a good show, everyone. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
All right, then. Did he actually leave?
All right. That happened.
He did actually leave. Okay. All right.
He did actually leave.
Okay. I just wanted to pop over to Discord to check. Well, I was glad he popped in. That was very drunk-alike. Okay.
Sorry. There was just a distortion in the reality for a second there. I was momentarily distracted.
So, cold tinnies of amber fluid, cold hard cash, a selection of beer and cheese, bottles of water, and energy drinks.
Beer I'm going to guess the first one.
What the hell's an esky?
Really? A cooler.
Oh.
Like, it's like a box.
Okay.
With ice in it.
Well, that makes sense.
Keep drinks cold. Esky.
Gotcha.
And
dressing up in
back.
A...
I'm ever so sorry. Is there another British person in the fucking?
Yes.
No, I'm
again. Is it Samuel again?
It is. No. Hello.
Yes. Jesus Christ, mate! It is. It is almost 9 a.m. What are we doing? What are we doing right now?
We are guiding far through the Christmas Aussie. Aussie Christmas quiz? Christmas Aussie quiz? One of the ways.
Yeah, one of the ways.
You know, you sound like... No, I meant me and you as people from the same country, but good God, you actually sound like I'm manager.
I could be.
May I please just slip into a Christmas quiz? I love a quiz. You know me, Polly.
Well...
Can I slip in?
You, if you could help with the Aussiness of it, because it's very Aussie.
Is it? Can I slip in, please,
yeah.
Polly?
Well, you have to join. Fucking hit the live button.
Can I please slip in, please, Polly? Is that any fucking better, far?
Is that how you hit on girls at the bar? Is that your line?
No, it wasn't, was it? It was worse. Worse.
It was worse. Okay. Let's see. Dressing up in a fur-lined suit isn't very smart on a scorching summer's day, so Santa should dress more appropriately for the summer down under. Of which of these is not appropriate for an Aussie summer clobber? Tacky dacks, thongs, boardies, or stubbies?
Tacky dacks.
That's
fucking like track pants.
Oh, are they?
Tracky dacks are tracksuit trousers, right?
Yeah, tracky dacks.
Yeah, I get that. I totally get that.
It is the dumbest name.
And thanks to Drunkle, I now know what clobber is, like a set of clothing.
Oh, you remember?
I remember. Yeah. Bing Crosby, It actually says Bing Crosby. That's what fucked me up. It's Crosby, you ignorant fucks.
Did it actually say Bing Crosby?
It does, yes. Bing Crosby. Look.
I don't think Bill Cosby famously.
Like, I admit I've been drinking, but I've got a reason for that one, okay? It just fucked me up two ways.
I'm not blaming you for shit right now. If you say it says fucking... Oh my... they did that on purpose.
No, I just think they're ignorant. They're Australian. They don't know who Bing Crosby is. They got me all fucked up. Okay, Bing Crosby.
famously dreamt of a white Christmas. But if an Aussie dreams of having a white Christmas and snowballs on Christmas Day, of what is he thinking? Cocaine, an Aussie Christmas fair, finding tissues after washing the clothes, ice in the esky, or he's got a few ruse loose on the top paddock. What the fuck?
None of those really made sense, did they?
No, this whole thing is...
Only one that made sense is ice and esky.
Yeah, to me as well.
That's just because it's cold.
Well, yeah, I mean, look, to be honest, when winter hits, we all get ice in our eskies, don't we? We just don't talk about it. But...
Okay. Australians let us barbecue for Christmas time is here. A time to stop and rest a bit and psych up for New Year. When the mercury is up to 30 or 40 degrees Celsius, a hot lunch isn't always the most welcome fare. Unless, of course, it's a Barbie. One of the most popular Aussie Christmas lunches consists of muddies, prawns, and bugs. What are the mad Aussies eating? Creepy crawlies from the garden, Vegemite sangas, bush tucker, or seafood?
Seafood.
Yeah, it's sea.
Do y'all call fucking prawns muddies and bugs as well?
I mean, far, do you?
I have no idea what the fuck they're referring to with muddies and bugs.
Hey, come on, you live in Australia. You're currently taking driving lessons upside down. Looking to you for answers right now, okay?
Yeah, and I'm telling you, I've...
And it's got bush tucker there. This is the only bush tucker we've seen tonight. What is a bush tucker, Far?
Bush tucker. Okay, that one I can explain. That's right. You go out in the bush. You find food that the Aboriginals would be eating, and you eat it. That will damp. Out in the bush. That's it.
Living off the land.
Basically, yeah.
Yeah.
Sleeping in the street, eating off the land.
That's what I'm saying. That phrase is not far away from me. I understand that. Probably because we invented you.
Right.
Bugs are a different thing, Polly. okay, fine, Gokado. Do y'all actually call sandwiches sangas?
They're not coming after you for the bug.
It's a slang term, but no, I've never heard anyone ever unironically call a sandwich sanger.
It's kind of like the British term, fucking sarnie.
Oh god, another song. Christmas in the Alice is like no other place I know. Santa doesn't like it much because there isn't any snow. His reindeer got all grumpy as the water holes go dry. For when it's stinking hot down there, it's bitchy hard to fly from Christmas in the Alice. Since the 1900s and before 2008, which Australian capital city has suffered through the hottest Christmas day on record? Perth, Melbourne, Brisbane, or Canberra?
Okay, what the fuck does that song have anything to do with any of that?
Yeah, because one of the answers was an Alice, so what the fuck?
Well, no, Alice Springs is in the Northern Territory, I'm pretty sure. None of those cities are in the Northern Territory. This has nothing to do with one or the other. What the fuck?
Canberra would be closest, wouldn't it?
Go with, you're a Perthite. Go with Perth.
Technicality.
Is it a Perthian?
Perthite.
Perthite. Well, I am from Perth.
A Perthican.
A Perthicary.
Yes.
Perthicary, that's nice. I like that. Perthicary.
Yeah. So, which one do you think is the hottest Christmas day on record? Perth, Melbourne, Brisbane, or Canberra? And I pronounce
them
somewhat properly for your sake.
Brisbane.
You want to go with Brisbane?
I would honestly go more with Brisbane because it's.
All right.
It's higher up.
Isn't that the city where the four guys had tortured all the people and put them in drums?
No, that's Adelaide.
Wait, hang on, what? Because that's warm.
Adelaide.
That's South Australia. That's got to bring the climate right up right there, right now.
That was Adelaide. Okay.
Like two Brisbane. Guys melting in drums. The average is going up right there.
Right. Okay, number seven. Yeah, we're almost there.
Brisbane is in Queensland.
Everyone knows the names of Santa's reindeer and the exploits of Rudolph, but what does Rolf Harris claim tows Santa's sleigh on his Australian run? Really? Even I know this. Come on, there's a half dozen albino cats.
Do you know Rolf Harris?
Well, that's his name after he got out of Germany after a certain ally ship arrived. And... I'm sorry. When your name is Rolf, you have to expect people are going to crack some Nazi jokes, okay?
Well, he is the kiddie to the
Right, so
that's right. Rolf Harris, the
kid.
Apparently, he's one of them people.
Yeah, he is.
And I use the term people loosely.
So we know him, right? Me, Drunkle and Sammy, we know him because we're from the same yard. Far, you know Rolf Harris because he's Australian?
Well, partially that, and because he's a kiddie dill. And because he wrote 6-5 Boomers.
Okay, alright, so you had me at kiddie diddler.
Yeah. Normally you'd have to look to immigrants to the UK to find them. Okay, moving along, number 8.
You don't know how true that is.
No, I follow the news. I'm well aware. Christmas, where the gum trees grow, there is no frost, and yes, there is no snow. Christmas in Australia is hot. Cold and frosty is what it's not. From Christmas, where the gum trees grow. Aussies love their barbecues, and more than just a few will be burning snags on December 25th. But we are nothing if not diverse. And there are other things we love to do for Christmas. Which one of these is not a favorite place to be? The beach, the picnic, swimming, or by a blazing fire?
Well, I'm straight up saying beach is definitely the best place to be, right?
By a blazing fire.
Best place to be.
Yeah, it's
because you're in Australia. Yeah, so you're going to go to the beach,
I'm saying
right?
that's not to be. Like, the fuck?
Albino Joeys have the best meat.
Wait, hang on. Not. All right. Where is not favorite? I'm sorry. The question was a bit stupid. Or maybe I'm a bit stupid. No, you're right. Blazing fire.
No,
because I was thinking if you had a you know, chopped up and dressed, you know.
Yeah.
Albino boomer, Joey, you'd want to be by a blazing fire to roast them up because they're.
I mean, that is a good shout, though, Polly. I'm not gonna lie, that is a good shout.
Okay.
I think they might have it all wrong, to be honest.
Yeah, this is what I'm saying. Like, we sell veal here. I don't understand why they're not selling Joey meat at a premium. Like, come on, they're not in danger.
I've eaten reindeer.
So have I. I've had reindeer.
How did you find it?
At a store.
Oh, well, I bought it.
Well, yeah, I didn't steal it from the store. I bought it as well.
It's too late for
that. How did you find it? I bought it from a store.
Yeah, first I got my rifle. Did then I went to Norway.
I thought it was good. It's a very, very rich meat, though. Yeah.
It reminded me of moose. Rich. I was surprised. I thought it was going to be very much like deer, and it's not. Dude, it's very much like moose.
Heard something so American is, you know what? I've had reindeer, but it kind of reminded me of moose.
What?
No, I would love to eat moose.
Yeah, it is the darkest of the red meats. It is so dark red.
Bison are coming back to the UK. I can't fucking wait, man. Yeah.
I mean, seriously, if you ever take a look at moose meat, it's darker than dolphin meat. It's like maroon.
I can't get you, but it tastes exactly like hamster.
Everything does if you plug your nose.
I strongly recommend that you try the moose before, you know, any other kind.
Oh, of course, yeah. Cleanse your palate.
Of course.
I'm sorry, Polly. Please continue. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
The penultimate question. While the traditional Christmas pud is a favorite on the menu, also very popular in Australia at any time of year, is a dessert named after a ballerina. What is the yummy dessert? Peach Melba, chocolate crackles, lamingtons, or pavlova?
Surely Ooh. It's pavlova. Like, that's a worldwide...
Yeah, Peach I'm Melba. Assuming it's Surely. Pavlova.
Peach Melba.
Lamingtons.
You honestly think, right, there was a ballerina called Peach Melba?
I think there was a ballerina named Gertrude Lamingtons. What's your... What?
No, there was a ballerina, and her name was Anna Melba. I'm pretty sure it was Anna Melba. Melba.
There was a ballerina named Chocolate Crackle. That also valid? Like, fuck's sake.
Way better than Chocolate Crackles, isn't it? Like, we're pushing the racial boat right out with Chocolate Crackles.
Final question for Summer Down Under is often associated with heat, drought, storms, and brush fires, and all sorts of other death and children dying in bouncy castles. Which one of the natural party poopers gate crashed Darwin's Christmas party in 1974? Temperatures of 53 degrees Celsius, Ash Wednesday brush fires, Cyclone Tracy, or empty dams? I thought that was what said clams.
Why do you say brush fires when it clearly says bush fires?
I don't. Bourbon. The answer is fucking bourbon is why I said brush fires, okay?
That is a legit answer. I'm fine with that. That's fine. I'm down with that. I think it was an American thing.
Myrtle Lamington. I apologize, Donald Leary.
1974. I don't know enough about Darwin in 1974 to give you an answer to that.
No one knows anything about Darwin right now except that they got a concentration camp nearby.
I can give you a secondary fact on Darwin. He is on the £10 note.
He got bombed in World War II. I can tell you that.
Well, we got Dom O'Leary.
The best.
We got Dom O'Leary trying to help you out in chat by saying Cyclone Tracy in all caps. You might want to go with that advice.
Okay, well, fuck that then. Like, Cyclone Tracy.
All right, we are gonna
Charles
test.
Charles Darwin got bombed.
No, the city of Darwin.
His grave, obviously, not the man himself.
Because he would come back. That's evolution, Polly. He cannot be allowed to come back.
All right, we are going to test Far's Aussiness now by submitting the answers. I have often maintained she actually lives in Brooklyn, and the accent is faked. Let's find out.
This is a terrible quiz.
Okay, well...
I think you're just a terrible Australian.
The bows of Waddle was correct, you were right.
The bows of what? Waddle?
Waddle. It's what they put on their... It's what they put on their sheds.
That's where turkeys apparently come from, the bows of Waddle. Like, it's like Amsterdam. Like, everyone knows where certain things come from.
Jesus Christ, look at the rest of the lyrics to this song. Deck the sheds. Deck the sheds with bows of waddle, ripper, bitchy, booty, bozzle, mate. Like, it is slice the cake and tip the bottle.
Real.
Ripper, bitchy, booty, bonza, mate.
This thing's fucking harsh as hell, Polly. What? Fucking...
Well, it sounds like drunken Dr. Seuss. Like, what the fuck?
I mean,
that can't be fucking real.
These they know it's Christmas time.
No, it's not bitchy, it's bloody. They're bloody. They're censoring out bloody.
Oh, bloody. I thought bitchy. It was bitchy. And they're censoring bloody. Why?
I thought it was bitchy.
It was true. I'm like, that can't be like legit, right? So I'm looking at it. Yeah, it's bloody.
See, I remember asking you, Drunkle, like, how bad of a swear really is bloody? And you said it's uncouth, but it's not that bad. But there apparently some people think it's pretty goddamn bad.
Hey, drunken Dr. Seuss is killing me right now. I can't hear anything after that. I'm fucking dying. That's incredible. Oh god. I'm holding my stomach.
I can fucking picture it. The cat in the hat was
fucker that he was. Leaving all around the house hairballs and fuzz. Okay, so we just so you were right about the cold tinnies in the of amber fluid is what you would find in an esky. Well done, well done.
Right.
Yeah, you were right about tracky dax. You were right about that. Well done, well done.
Yeah, tracky bombs.
Okay, ice in the esky is wrong. The correct answer is Aussie Christmas fair.
Oh.
Bing Cosby.
You're never going to pass. You're never going to pass your driving test. You can't get this shit right. You realize this.
It was asking.
Yeah, I don't.
Where would you look for balls of ice? And it's referencing snowballs as like a dessert, along with rum balls as confectionaries typically enjoyed over Christmas.
Oh, it's a fucking... Okay.
It's a pudding. It's a pudding, Samuel. It's a pudding.
Coconut pudding.
It's a goddamn Knickerbocker gory all over again.
And there's 225 grams of kofa.
Great, yeah, perfect.
Tell you what,
I don't know.
500 grams too less, mate. I love me some kofa.
Is that how you spell cocoa down there?
I want to say
no,
coffa.
No, it's something else.
Coffa? What is it? Don't say, what is it? It's cocaine, isn't it?
Sorry?
It's a registered trademark. It's a form of vegetable fat. Okay.
It's just a thing you add into, like, usually, like chocolate crackles and shit like that.
That's fine, but you seem to be so secretive about this. You had to ask 3 times before you said what it was.
Oh, fuck you. I ask you questions about Britain all the time, and you just give me smart-ass answers and tell me the fuck off.
Oh, don't. Come on, we're making fun of a different foreigner tonight. Kofa might be a little more sensitive.
I can't recommend for you to eat this far. It is 100% fat, at least 98% of which is saturated. Please don't eat this stuff.
Whoa!
You add it to other things.
That's in your pudding?
you don't, like, eat this on its own.
I'm worried for your health, Far. Don't eat that stuff.
Ice cream and fat. Right?
I mean, to be fair, Drunkle, the British do have shit like suet pudding.
Dude, come on, we're on the same side here. Why are you doing this to me?
He's French.
Yeah.
He's not on the side, man.
Is he fucking French?
He's French. He's not even British. It's just...
Well, then do what you're used to doing and shut the fuck up. I'm sorry, bro. I don't mean that. Lovely to have one.
Okay, so anyway, yeah, seafood is correct, so apparently muddy bugs are other names for prawns. No, the correct answer was Perth. Perth in 1968 had the hottest Christmas on record. You win, Far.
Great, I would like to thank climate, hole in the ozone layer.
I would like to thank China and India. I would like to thank all of the Indian rural people for burning dung as fuel. Thank you very much. Greatly appreciated.
Yeah.
The answer far is 42 degrees Celsius on Christmas Day in 1968 was the record.
Great.
That's mental.
Now, what's that in actual?
Up until now.
What's that in actual? Units for people that have actually put a man on the moon.
By 232.
Oh, it's 107. That's not. I mean, that's hot, but it's like Christmas Day. That sucks. I mean, that's.
Oh, don't give us that. She literally lives in Australia. It's like God's magnifying glass. They are the ants.
Thank you, Drunkle. I guess.
No, I feel your pain, mate. Obviously, you shouldn't have committed crimes, otherwise you wouldn't be there now.
Yeah, okay. Like, fun fact, my family did not end up over here because I committed crimes. I'm like,
what the hell?
They just look like criminals in the photos. Yeah. It's different.
They went over by choice, Polly. They were like, hey, oh, a load of criminals. Seems like my kind of guys.
Yeah, like they chose to come here for some godforsaken reason.
Well, they couldn't afford a flat in London that was becoming less English month by month, so they moved to some place.
Fair play on that, Molly.
It becomes even more baffling when it's like, oh yeah, one of them actually owned land in England. Why the fuck did they move?
Hats off to you right now. I mean, Australia is like London, but on fucking hard mode. it's not just the people that want to kill you, but it's the fucking environment as well.
And they're next door to China. Yeah. It's England on hard mode. That's a good description. I like it.
Hey, it's Indonesia offering us.
Yeah.
Not quite next door.
Oh yeah, for the 2 minutes it'll take for China to take Indonesia.
Half a dozen albino kangaroos.
They can hide out.
As written by Anons, you were right about that.
What?
The guy who wrote Far also destroyed another
Rolf poisoned. Harris. I just told you about Rolf Harris.
That's Rolf Harris apparently is Anons.
Okay, I thought you were saying like this was written by R.G. Anons. Like an author, but no, it's just very strange to hear the word nonce in that accent.
Fit in, okay?
Surely you mean that. No.
Yeah, it threw me for a fucking loop and all.
It's Christmas! I said that.
I'm trying to fit in. When in Rome, or in this case, France, England, and Australia, do as the French, England, and Australians do.
I appreciate it. It just takes a minute to get used to. I'm sorry.
This is a multi-continental stream, isn't it, actually?
It really is.
I didn't stop thinking about that till right now. Fuck. Because
you're coming back to the whole thing of Britain is not in Europe again.
Yes, I am. I firmly believe that. Britain is not a part of Europe. Yes. It's an island, literally. I mean,
it's not a part of the European Union.
Thank fuck.
Yeah, but that's like saying Russia's part of Europe. I mean, Russia's arguably more a part of Europe than fucking Britain is.
How dare you? You take that back.
Look, dude, are you French or are you British? What the fuck? Pick a fucking side. What are you doing?
I'm French.
Well, then shut. What are you doing?
Then what are you doing?
What are you doing?
Okay,
answer.
He's speaking English.
I don't know what.
What's he doing?
Pick a side. You know?
I don't know. Cuss him out in fucking French, Sam. Let him know. There you go. It's just.
Where's the Merovingian speech?
That's what I was, because that's what I was thinking about, right? I don't know if anybody out there remembers the Merovingian from the second and third installments of The Matrix. There's this one point where he says, "I love the French language." He goes, especially when you swear. And then he says off this long...
Oh, it's Matrix. Is third Matrix?
That's the second Matrix where he does that.
Oh, and he... but he's got that fucking banging ass wife.
Oh, yeah. Yes, he does.
I know. Oh, yeah, okay. I know exactly.
Yeah, no one remembers the Merovingian. They remember Persephone, his wife. Yeah.
Oh, that's... yes.
And he runs off this huge cuss line, and he says, I love it. It's like wiping your ass with silk. And I was like, Sam, translate this for me. So he goes and listens. He goes, what was it? He said that you told me it was like nonsensical, just cuss in a row that didn't really.
Yeah, it doesn't make an awful lot of sense. I can read it for you if you want.
No, I'd rather you cuss out Drunkle in French.
I would quite like to hear that. I'll tell you what, mate, because of course, foreigner, she's Hungarian.
and we'll watch something, and it'll just say, you know, speaks in Hungarian as you go, that was bullshit. I've dated a fucking French girl. We've watched, you know, we did the Netflix and chill, and she said that was bullshit. I was friends with a genuine Japanese a long time ago, and we went to a sushi bar. It wasn't a
Chinese garbage, pretending right? to be Japanese. It was a genuine one.
It was genuine Japanese.
Okay. And she looked at the menu, and the menu was written in English, and underneath that it was written in kanji, and she went, that is fucking bullshit, right? So I tell you what, sometimes, right, in Europe, people bullshit. When it comes to other languages, absolutely.
Well, hey, they do the same thing in Japan.
Tosh.
They do the exact same thing.
No, that is a real country, Far. That is a real country. It's not
yeah,
fake. It's there.
But they go, but they, like, you read it, and it's like in English, and that's how you get English. It's great. I don't see the point of getting pissed. It's hilarious.
I will tell you where that joke came from about the authentic Japanese person. If you go to anywhere but like the super high-end sushi places in America, I can tell you this from like personal experience. You go in there and they're all Chinese. They're not Japanese. All the people that run it, the people that own it, and they're like,
it's not real sushi.
They're like, stupid Americans don't know any better. And it's like, you know, they've got like, you know, samurai swords on the wall that they bought from the county fair.
Are they wrong?
What? Well, I'm just pointing it out. It's like, I'm looking behind the counter and they've got like a calendar that's in Mandarin. And I'm like, you think I'm a fucking moron? You don't think I can fucking tell? And like listening to you talk, Japanese sounds very much different than Mandarin, than Cantonese. You can like, you know, Japanese are like, we've all listened to, you know, anime. But when you hear two people speaking Cantonese and it's like, okay, that, no, you are not Japanese people.
I mean, what you're saying right now is probably going to get you banned, but you have an actual point right here. The elongated vowels when it comes to Cantonese and Mandarin. That is Cantonese and Mandarin, right?
Yeah, that is that. And I have always fascinatingly wondered, like, what tick of the language, what facet of the language it is that you can hold the last word. Like, imagine if I said, Sam, how are you doing today? Like, it would just be, what the fuck?
Arigato gozaimasu!
Would you say that? I mean, you'd be like, yo, Sam, what's up?
Of course, Uncle comes in to disprove that whole fucking thesis.
Now, here's the thing. I could, like, speak in gibberish to imitate the sound of the language, and everyone's like, oh, that's racist, whatever. Are you kidding me? I have been dying for years to hear somebody imitate English in gibberish. What would it sound like?
Have you not checked your Discord DMs from me to you? I sent you an Italian song, but I think it was from the 80s, right?
Yeah, the Italian song where they do that, right?
Yeah, thank you.
Just
what was his name?
Gibberish.
Prince and Cordo Crown and Anchuso. All right. Right. This is a time, it was in the 70s, where Italy was absolutely obsessed with any song that was in English. And this guy, total fucking badass, balls deep musician, went, all right, I guarantee if I make a song sound English, they'll still eat it up. So he did it, and it was complete gibberish. None of the lyrics are actually any kind of human language that we know of right now. And it is it's a banger, isn't it?
It is.
It's a
good song.
Polly, I sent it to you with that explanation, mate. Check your fucking Discord DMs,
from like how many months ago? Or do you mean recently?
A couple of days ago. It was literally before Lou Bega on Monday, yeah. I sent you a video.
Hmm. Well... okay, I will.
Because I'm a sucker for brass, right? And even though he's actually not saying anything, the lyrics don't mean anything, but it's still pure music because of it, you know, because like the lyrics don't mean anything. He's not going, oh, love, love, love.
like most songs normally do. But this little phrase just oh, I love it, man.
There's a fucking word for that, though, isn't there, drunk? Is it like lilting or something?
I think it's called French, Samuel. I'm sorry, bro. Love you.
See, I mean, Uncle Mike, you mentioned there's videos on YouTube of English to non-English speakers, like what it sounds like to them. And I listened to it, and I was, it was interesting. I ended up watching the whole video, but
what's
I was kind of
swearing.
I was kind of disappointed because they were using words. And it's like, no, because when I was just doing an impression of Cantonese there, like, it was pure gibber. It was just sounds. You know what I mean? Like, where they
but
were...
It still made sense, though, because it is... I mean, that's from a West End perspective. It is just sound. That's us, right?
Right.
I mean, I'm sorry, you're doing the psychology, but I'm just... from our point of view, it is just... gibberish, and that, in if you watch that on a fucking TV program or something like that, it's gonna be like, oh, so they're speaking foreign, okay.
They're speaking, they speak the foreign.
You know what I mean?
By the way, Fart, you got 8 out of 10, and you're above average, which was 7 out of 10.
Hey,
there you go. If you don't cheer up, there'll be no more games for you. I know. Don't threaten you with exactly what you wanted. I get it.
Yeah, exactly. Right? Like, what? You're gonna give me exactly what I want? I don't have to do another one of these. Wow. Thanks, Paul.
Can I suggest a game?
Well, we were just about to wrap up. It's last call.
Well, okay. Oh, okay.
But we're doing another one tomorrow night if you'll be here and drunk. So, and you've got one of those covered.
I don't. No, if I will, because I'll wear the next day. But what I'm saying is because we've got myself here, obviously a Brit. You've got Farr, who's Australian, and you've got Samuel, who's French. What if we were to take the American citizenship test?
Ooh, good one.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Yeah, I sense Farr's excitement at this idea.
Yeah. I think I sensed it too.
But like, what test is this? Like, is this something you found online, or is this?
Oh yeah,
just
they have tests, like questions from previous exams and stuff. It's like, how many members are there in the House of Representatives?
50.
No.
322.
No. It's over. It's the same number as the number of congressional districts, if that helps. Because there's one for every congressional district.
That just really helps, Polly.
Just 435.
Oh. 435. Yeah, that's awesome.
Okay, here's a better one. How many senators are there in the Senate?
Yes.
72.
101.
Okay, that's an interesting number. Okay, Farr, how many senators are there in the Senate?
102.
There's 100. There's two from every state. There's 100.
The VP has the ability to break ties. The VP has the ability to break ties in the Senate. They have senatorial power.
They're not a member of the Senate, though. They're a member of the executive branch.
But they all went over Price is Right rules.
They did, so you won.
Yeah.
Ebony's first guess was 432, which is pretty goddamn close. Okay, wait a minute. If there is one electoral college vote for every congressional district, why are there 438 electoral college votes if there's 435?
Is that a genuine question, or is that something you found on Twitter?
No, I'm asking that question right now, because most people are like, I don't understand, there's 435. Where does the extra three come from? Where do the extra three come from?
Larger population areas, isn't it?
I don't know. You guys both talked at the same time. I heard the English gibberish I was looking for earlier.
No, you didn't. I was the one quiet one.
Oh. What'd you say, Sam?
Oh, I would imagine it's either got to do with split districts or filibustering.
No. Far?
I kind of just assumed larger population things.
No.
Like, you have, you know, New York, then you have actual New York State.
No.
I'm gonna push out and go to us.
The Supreme Court gets votes in the Electoral College?
Yeah, well, I mean, you say it like that, so no, I wanna say something else.
Dr. Functional guest territories. Not a bad guess, you know? Yeah, you got, like, Guam and Puerto Rico and whatnot, but no, that's not the answer.
Good bit of Guam, yeah.
Yeah.
No,
District of Columbia. The three votes are for the District of Columbia, because they're not a state, they're a district.
Columbia only really gets to say if there is a fucking stupidly fucking, like, oh, if it's split right down the middle in the whole of America. Now, Columbia, now you get to say something.
Okay, let's go straightforward and simple. The first president of the United States was George Washington. Everyone knows that. Who was the first vice president?
Wayne the Rock Johnson.
You nailed it. Fucking. He's longer lived than you'd think. Not actually, if you've seen him lately. He's looking pretty old these days.
No, he's not looking good, is he?
No.
I've never...
I'll give you a hint.
One of the other family. Hold on.
I'll give you a hint. The first vice president of the United States was also the second president of the United States. Same guy.
Oh, John Adams.
Man, John Adams. There you go.
That was a bear.
I mean, it probably is.
Only.
The last call, eh?
Yeah. The only two sons. Have ever had their that were presidents, ever had their fathers serve as president as well. Who were they?
Cain and Abel.
One is obviously Bush.
George W. Bush.
Yeah. George Bush.
Yeah. Who's the second one whose father also served as president? Same last name.
Kennedy?
No. There's only
Bush.
One.
Bush.
Nope.
It's the same last name.
Yeah. Well, yeah, they're father and son, Bush, man. Well, yeah, Bush, but somebody already guessed that. I said there were two. Do I need to bring up back the Fry Bush
no,
of...
No, you said no.
Yeah.
Wait, no, it's John, it's Adams again.
It is, John Quincy Adams.
Yeah, John Quincy Adams.
Yeah.
I know so much. Well, no,
I used to live in the States. You pick up a few things.
No, that's fair, yeah. Yeah, I mean, I obviously most of your history is just people getting beheaded. It's really easy to memorize.
It's not wrong. It's not wrong. It's absolutely fucking true.
Easy. Someone brings up an enemy, yeah, beheaded. What about this guy? Yeah, beheaded.
I was going to say,
it's 50-50.
Henry VIII is the rhyme, right? There's a little rhyme for Henry VIII, whereas for us it's... Beheaded. Ooh, survived. Beheaded.
Divorced, beheaded, died. Divorced, beheaded, survived. Do you like beheaded?
That's
beheaded,
the
beheaded,
one.
Beheaded. All right.
Brilliant.
Hey, I learned French today.
Well, I mean, I could be a dick about this. It's like, examples of naturalization tests for U.S. citizenship. 10 questions. Why do we show loyalty when we say the Pledge of Allegiance? We don't say it anymore because it's been outruled by social Marxists. We don't say the Pledge of Allegiance anymore. That would be wrong. How many Americans can even recite the Pledge of Allegiance? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States and the Republic for which it stands. I can do it, but that's because, you know, I'm not an America-hating traitor. Name one right only... U.S. citizens have?
Free speech. No. Freedom of religion. No. Free speech.
No.
Right to bear arms?
No.
No.
Ah, God, no.
People with green cards... People with green cards can have the right to keep and bear arms because they're permanent residents.
The right to form a militia.
No, that's same thing, Second Amendment.
But if it's fire plane's going over the belt.
There's only there's only
going air, right?
It's an odd one to run for federal office.
Oh, of course it is. Yeah. Of course it is. Well, same here, pretty well.
The House of Representatives has how many voting members? And the answer is 435. We already went over that. What is freedom of religion? It's a thing used to protect Muslims while denying, while calling Christians a bunch of fundamentalist scum. The idea of self-government is in the first three words of the Constitution. What are these words? Please tell me, somebody, give me the answer. What are the first three words of the Constitution? I'll be back are not the first three words of the Constitution, Far.
No, also, that's four words. We the people.
We the people is correct, yes. I'll be back is three words. I'll be back.
No, it's not. It's four.
It's there's a contraction.
I will. It's four fucking words.
No, contractions count as one word, Sam. Let's not be pedantic.
No, they don't. It's not, it's how just... dare you with the double space?
Look, I can't leave it. It's a Braxton Hicks contraction. All right.
Can we keep in mind that Farr is the one who wanted to do this the least? Farr is the one with no interest in any of this material, and Farr is the one that wants to move to the United States. Let's all keep that in mind. It's just wonderful.
She's not the only one. I'm gonna go back over there.
I love this. It says number nine on here is name one problem that led to the Civil War. The answer is slavery. But the question is name one problem implying others, which there were: free navigation of the Mississippi, states' rights, international trade.
Quartering. I just really like the word quartering.
But of course, you're English. It was a form of punishment for those who were disloyal to the king.
Maybe
you're onto something.
Fighting sucker to those in need.
I just like the idea of quartering, because, like, even though they're going, hey, soldiers can stay in your own houses, it's like, hey, it's just 1/4 of the problem. There's a lot more going on here.
Okay, you're into quartering then, are you? No quartering in private homes during peacetime? What amendment is that?
When it comes to YouTubers, he is 100% too fat for my liking.
Well, that was an excellent example of a non sequitur. What the fuck just happened?
I know a YouTuber. What the fuck? Come on. One time.
It's not the First Amendment. It's not the Second Amendment.
Mm-hmm. Just going sequentially until I say yes? Is that what's
going on? The Second Amendment is the right to bear arms.
It's not the Fourth Amendment.
Well, the first.
But who? What's the Third Amendment? The oft overlooked Third Amendment.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Polly, that's your quiz.
No, I already. That's the one about no quartering in homes during peacetime. The Third Amendment. Jesus Christ.
There we go.
You say it to me like I'm an idiot.
Well, no, but you're saying that's your question. No, that's the question I'm actually asking you right now.
In the Europe, it's called the Thirdering. Our armies were a little bit bigger.
Actually, the Third Amendment was specifically about your army. No quartering of British soldiers in private colonial homes.
Oh, we got our own specific thing in the Constitution. That's nice. So you're telling me, right? So if someone fucking, an American woman marries a British soldier and they move in together in America, she's actually committed treason.
No,
she's committed treason.
No, a home cannot be turned into a barracks at the owner's expense, is what they're saying, which is exactly what the British were doing.
Just describe marriage.
So he can live there, he just can't have his mates over.
That's basically it, yeah. Right.
There, well, okay, interesting. Right. Interestingly, that's Drunkle, fun. You said, oh, we've got our own amendment that specifically references us. All 10 of them do, all the way down the line. Every amendment is about a British usurpation or trampling of the rights of freeborn Englishmen in the colonies. That's how they became amendments.
I feel honored. However, Samuel here is not even mentioned. That's got to hurt, bruh.
Well, that's because the amendments were, you know, broadly speaking, against the British, and we kind of helped toss you guys out. So, I am completely okay with this.
All right.
Oh dear.
Well, that's enough pointless history, drunken history for tonight. Drunken history, that's a good channel. All right, so.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Oh, that is a great channel, by the way.
Yeah, it really, really. Is it still active, actually?
I've never actually watched it. I don't know if it's a channel. I've actually watched it on fucking streaming services. It's done quite well for itself.
Oh, you mean people were like, I watched it on YouTube, so I must have been watching postings of, like, you know, copyrighted material sort of thing.
Dude, it's a legit show, yeah. Not just that, but you've got UK drunken history as well, you know?
Oh, nice.
Yeah, it's a fucking, I mean, which is nice because, you know, there's a little, the things that are misconception, you know?
Yeah.
And we find out what, you know, what really happened, but then also, you're trusting a drunk Z-list celebrity to tell you what really happened? Maybe they're not misconceptions after all. I don't know. Keeps you guessing.
Quite.
Hot luck.
All right, on that note, it's definitely way past third, fourth call. So we're gonna... I'd like to thank everybody who came kept us company tonight, came back to 1942. I'd like to thank everybody who tipped the bartender and Far. I'd like to thank everyone who kept me company at the bar tonight. That would be FarZoosme, Sam, and Drunkle. You guys are awesome. So.
We're awesome.
Thank you.
Oh, you made it back. Sweet. Good. Yeah.
I did.
We have plans to do another one tomorrow night, which should be fun because it's the Christmas season. So we're going to be doing extra noir bars because Far insisted. So I said, okay.
Oh, excellent.
You're the one that insisted, but I'm not complaining. So
that's not the way I remember it, but all right.
You remember a lot of things very oddly.
Thank you all. Why would anyone complain?
Noir Bar,
thank you.
Chill as fuck. Christmas season, fantastic. Yep. That's what we want, right?
Right. And we've even got a Judy Garland up. I mean.
For fuck's sake.
Oh, God. How long have you been waiting to say that? Jesus Christ.
What are you talking about? I've been saying since last year that Judy Garland is a Noir Bar original. It's...
Yeah, but you only get to say it once a year.
No, I repeat it over and over again. Trust me. It is the greatest wordplay ever.
And this, ladies and gentlemen, is why I drink in the Noir Bar. Good night, all.
Have a good night, everybody. And now, as we always say about this time, you don't gotta go home, but you gotta get the hell out of here. And remember,